Welcome back to another evening of Sultans and Sorcery. When we left the group, they had just found the ruined city of Isilungu. After killing a few of the roaming Yuan Ti residents, Bechtold getting greedy and getting attacked by a mimic.
Dude, he wasn't greedy. don't do that crap twice in a row.
Okay, Bechtold, unfortunately, at the DM's discretion, was assaulted by a mimic. The group came upon three human figures. It was the adventurers they were looking for. Or so they thought. Through their cunning wit and wisdom, they determined that these three figures were lying about their identities and were then assaulted by three jackalwares, which they dealt with effortlessly. Now, having uncovered seemingly a small bedroom or small lodging quarters, the group found a note. We were fortunate to find that secret passage right upon entering this labyrinth. The denizens we face here are difficult indeed, but we will find the Orb of Light. For now, though, this room looks like an ideal place to rest before tackling on this dungeon in earnest. Husam. So then, where are the adventurers? And our story begins.
Sleeping.
Yeah, I was just saying, taking a nap.
This group of adventurers. All right, so we never did it. You guys leveled up to level 4. At this point, you may choose to take either a short or long rest. If you take a long rest, you may want to take some precautions to keeping the area secure, because who knows what may be roaming around.
So before we choose, can I drag all the bodies into this room? I'm going to drag them to right here in front of the door. I'm going to close the door and put them up against the door.
All right.
Making a human barricade or whatever they were.
Okay. Oh, okay. You're going to use the bodies?
Oh, we were
going to
push the table in front if we were going to use
it. Well, the table's already there. I'm putting bodies on top of it to add weight.
All right. There are bodies on top of the table. I don't really have a table to put there, but all right. The door is now closed and barricaded.
So apparently we're going to take a long rest now that he's done all that.
We don't have to, but I figured just in case. I mean, I only sleep for 4 hours. I was bored. I'm just dragging bodies around.
You sleep for 4 hours, but you still got to, you know, chill out for the other four. But no, I honestly think we're probably good to go on. Dakar, how are you doing?
Could use the rest.
You left a pretty long blood trail in dragging those
That's
bodies.
That's awesome.
I mean, I can stay awake if you guys want to take a long rest. I'm not missing any HP. I didn't really use any abilities.
I was gonna say, well, if we take a long rest, everybody should go ahead and long rest and get everything back.
I'm not missing anything.
Well, the main
you're missing health.
Without
he's
at max.
He's
health,
not.
Just like
I'm max.
Oh, Bechtold is missing health.
Yeah, Bechtold. That's what I'm saying. Like to heal up Bechtold because he's.
But he's got hit dice. So
he's got hit dice. If you want to recover any spells, Dekar, I'll go ahead and let you know because you weren't available at the time. I think you have only 2 spell slots left.
No. He only used 2 first level spells. He just cast Cure Light Wounds twice.
Okay. I thought he tried at least a couple Scorchies. Whatever.
Long rest.
It is y'all's decision, but.
I told you to say something.
A long rest would let me get my bardic inspiration back.
Oh, yeah, that's right, because you used all of
then
those.
I'm gonna vote for a long rest, and I'll stay awake and keep watch.
Yeah, okay, who's choosing to stay awake? Mateo?
Mateo
and I can just split it.
Y'all can split it? All right.
Yep.
So I just have these markers to indicate you guys are the ones not resting. Everyone else just spreads themselves out across the beds.
Could play a mean game of bones.
Okay. Why is Dakar? That's a table.
That's the table that was moved into the over the door to barricade it.
There's a really nice bed in the bottom right corner.
Oh.
What's the Don't worry line? About the green that you see on the floor.
I fixed that.
I think it was Eldrin that already triggered the trap.
Yep.
Yeah. Oh.
The chest that you see next to the bed is
not a mimic.
Is not a mimic. It is actually completely empty.
Somebody threw their sword at it, if I remember correctly.
I did.
Yeah. Like, not twice
in
a row.
I do remember this. Okay. So, you go through a rest. Let me roll something to see what happens.
Long rest is full HP recovery,
full
right?
HP and yep. Half of your hit die are recovered.
Oh, only half? That was all hit dice.
Half your hit die.
Okay. Anyway, all HP is recovered, all spell slots are recovered, anything that recharges on long rest, like Bardic Inspiration, is recovered. Everyone set yourselves to full. Mateo and Akka, since you chose not to rest, you may make a perception check.
That's a good bell. Oh, okay, yeah, that will go well. Thank you.
All right. Together, after studying the note, you realize how could they have gotten in here? He says there's a secret passage. And so you start looking around and such for any kind of passages. Nope, get out of my face. And you do find a secret passage with a stairwell entering to what it seems to be a dead end.
So we found a secret.
Is this happening while everybody's asleep? I take it we find this?
Yes.
So it's pretty much just. Okay. Yeah, I mean, you want to go down and make another perception check, Akka? We'll see if we find anything.
I'm going to give him this long look. No. You don't wear any heavy armor. I don't have any armor. And I also spent, you know, about, I think it's 10 minutes. Hang on, I got to look at the spell again. An hour and 10 minutes. And I summoned up a fiendish spider that I've been playing with while on watch.
Oh, shit. I need a token for your spider. All right, let me get that real quick.
I mean, it's tiny, so it's not a big deal. So, no, I've been... You know, checking out this book. Oh, and then, you know, summoning an unseen servant to cruise around with me, too.
Mm. I guess
what
I've
kind
spent this time
what kind of spider is this,
Akka?
What kind of spider is this?
It's like a little tarantula. Just, you know, with kind of glowing red eyes and kind of, you know. It's fiendish.
Fiendish. Well, that's special.
Yeah, I was going to say that. You're not going to find a token with fiendish spider, I don't think.
No. I'm just going to my familiar's book.
You sure you don't want to go down and check it out?
Yeah, no, I'm going to wait till everybody is awake, because it could be nothing. On the other hand, it could be more, you know, snake people. And I have no desire to fight snake people while everybody else is asleep.
What color is your spider?
Probably a dark blue.
Hey! There he is.
Hey, that works.
All right.
Except he's tiny, but yeah, that works.
Yeah, I will. Let me see what layer he's on. And I will give you control over this spider. And if he has any stats, you can enter them in.
Oh!
And you can give him a name as you choose.
Here you go. You can share this one with the folks. Nah, there it is. That's what it looks like. Thank you for that, Bechtold.
You're welcome.
Where did you? Okay.
That's adorable.
Yes, so I have a camel and a spider, and I can also summon an unseen servant. Yep.
So
I got me a little entourage.
You can put that with the folks. Or I could just put it here. I think. No, I can't.
We could send your spider down to go look.
I could do that, actually. All right, so I'm going to command my fiendish spider to head down here. And
I'll move to the top of the stairs while he's doing this, just in case.
Yeah. Yeah. Let me look my spell back up and make sure I don't think I have to throw my vision into him, my senses into him, while I tell him to go scout a place out. I think I just tell him to go do that, and he does. Find familiar. So I do have to use an action. So I am temporarily blind and deaf, but I perceive everything from his point of view, so I'm going to have it skitter up the wall and onto the roof, or no, not the roof, the ceiling, and skitter across to see what I can see down there. So it's just a dead end, that's it?
Yeah, it's just a dead end.
All right, then I will roll perception again.
Through the spider. What is the spider's perception?
It will use my skills because I'm using my... I am looking through...
Really?
I am using
okay.
my eyes, or well, its eyes, but it's still my skills.
Really? And, okay, yeah. That's cool. I'll look
that
up later.
More eyes?
I'll look. He might get advantage, but it doesn't matter. It just appears to be a dead end.
Yeah, apparently it's not just a dead end. I am well aware of that. I just can't find anything, guys.
All you want me to go down then? I can go down by myself, or we just wait for everybody and we'll do it then.
I was gonna say, why don't we just wait? I mean, based on the note, there's clearly some kind of secret entrance. It's probably safe, but it could be trapped, and I have no way of healing you, so...
That's true. We could just send down the trap checker, Eldrin.
Yeah.
That's also a great hallway for some Thunderwave.
It is a great... I mean, it's perfectly shaped for Thunderwave.
Out of character, John, I have a story for you at the end of the night.
I resemble that remark, trap checker.
All right, so everyone wakes back up, fully rested, refreshed, as fresh as you could possibly be in such a cold, dark place as this.
I'm a bard. I'm always fresh.
Hey.
So fresh and so clean.
And where do you go? You have a couple passages from your origin that you did not check. You have this seemingly dead-end room that
right.
someone could check.
Well, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to poke the stairs with my sword to make sure it's not a mimic.
It's got PTSD now.
All right. Eladrin, you're stealth for now.
Yeah, to what a wall.
I'm going to call my spider back and kind of get... We'll, you know, Mateo and I can...
I'm going to go... Well, yeah, I guess I'll explain to everybody. We'll explain that while everybody was sleeping, we kind of found this passageway leading down. So far, we haven't found anything special about it, but we waited for everybody to go down. And I'm also going to go stealth as well.
All right. They mentioned that they had the idea because it came from that note. But then if they came from this way, where were they heading? You don't know.
Is there any leftover, like... long pieces of wood or anything like that in the room?
Depends what you want to do with it. I mean, there's a table, there's a chair.
Set traps off.
Oh. You want a 10-foot pole.
Yeah.
10-foot pole.
You know what we could
do? You can break a leg off of the chair.
Okay. I have a chair leg and I start poking my way down the stairs.
We could take that table back to the initial room and throw it on top of that cloth square we found.
Oh, we have bodies for that.
Wait. Take the table, turn it upside down, and
slide
it down the stairs.
Yep.
It'll set off any kind of pressure plate on any steps that there are.
I helped Dakar do that.
Well, if you're talking about these stairs, the spider went down the stairs.
No, it didn't. It went down.
It went
along
the
roof.
Wall.
I mean, I thought it went along the freaking floor, and then it got on the roof. Whatever.
No, dude, it's a spider. It's on the ceiling all the time.
All the time. Got it. All right.
Well, actually, when I put that little symbol on it, that means I'd use an action to dismiss it to a extra-dimensional space.
Cool.
Within my robes.
Cool. Okay. So you guys take this table, and you want to slide it down the stairs. Yes, that's what you said.
Yep, yes. That's the plan.
Yes, sir.
Wait, I still have glowing teeth, right?
This isn't going to be. This is not an acceptable plan unless somebody is writing on it.
I'm doing it. I've done
so
this before in other games.
So leave one of the dead bodies on it when it goes down.
No. I've done this in other games. I'm doing it. I rode down a shield and kicked a boss in the face. I'm doing it again.
All right. So we put Eladrin on the table and shove it down the stairs.
Acrobatics. Eladrin,
make a surf check.
Yeah, so acrobatics.
Holy crap.
Good job.
You go down the stairs, bumbling along this table that you have turned into a surfboard, and crash into the wall with a loud sound.
I wish you guys had camera for me right now. I'm facepalming so hard.
So he's at the bottom of the stairs or, like, all the way to the wall?
Wherever the table would stop.
Yeah, yeah, that's a fair point. So Akka is going to kind of lean over. Hey, while you're down there, see if you find a secret door.
Perception?
Bechtel, watching, just says, it's going to make a great perception story.
Yeah.
Did I pass my stealth roll, by the way? It was an 8.
Oh, God. What am I willing to have?
You have advantage knowing that people already came through here.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, God.
I'm putting Will and Wheaton to rest right now.
Yeah, it's a secret door, and you see, like, out into this hallway, the connecting staircase from before, and even the beginning of some kind of cave.
Kellen's going to go down and stand next to him.
Before we go too far, I'm saying this in character, does anybody remember where they, the Jackalwares said the storage room was? Wasn't it?
It was north.
That was.
They said it was the Jackalwares said a storage room was to the north.
Do we want to go check there first? Because clearly these Jackalwares have seen Hassam and Thana and the other guy.
Is this a door right here?
Where? Hold down left click and ping
excuse
it.
Me?
Oh, yes. That's
a... Yes, that is a door.
Yeah, so that's...
I don't know, do you guys want to... That would be north. I mean, do you want to go check that?
There's two doors out there.
Yeah. That's kind of my thought before we go exploring any cave. Because my thinking being, they're imitating the adventurers, the people that were seeking. So clearly they've seen them. So perhaps they're being held captive in the storage room?
Can we close that secret door at the bottom? Is there any way to lock it or to make this room safe once again?
Yeah, as you run your hand along the wall, you find a loose rock, you push it in, and the door just kind of swings back in. It had swung out, that way it wouldn't trap anyone who tried to open it from this side. And so now that this passage down here, the tiny one, if it would let me ping... is closed off again.
Cool.
Okay. Yeah, I just want to make sure we're safe from the rear.
Mm-hmm.
So you guys want to explore north or south first? Are those two doors?
Also,
Eladrin, since you were the one that did the surfing and like collided with the door and you had low light vision, you see into this cave a little bit. You see it just kind of continues.
Let's just do this south door.
Smaller area?
Yeah, that's my thought.
Okay. Determine any kind of marching order you guys want to go out. Akka's just going to run. All right, Kellen and Eladrin, this door is already partially open. You could just swing it open.
Okay.
I love how we're stacked up SWAT style.
We've already been so damn loud with my surfing. I'm just going to kick the damn thing in.
Yeah.
That and, you know, thunderclap.
You find...
Wasn't
like
thunderclap right outside this door?
Thunderwave,
you find just, like, another small little chamber where... It seems like just another chamber of lodging for the Yuan-Ti.
They're sleeping pads, right? Not actual beds.
Yeah, those are just sleeping pads.
How heavy are these sleeping pads?
I'm going to move into the room and do a perception check.
I mean, it's a bedroll.
Okay.
I take an extra bedroll.
Okay, sure. Just mark it on your inventory.
You never know when we might need another sheet.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. You find nothing of interest in this room.
Okay.
Alright, so shall we continue north?
Yeah.
Does anybody else have something to do in the room?
Nope, I got my bedroll.
Okay.
Actually, you know what? Is that candle still going?
No, you guys have rested. No, it's definitely burned out by now.
Aww.
Is Descartes dead?
Yes, Jim. You still with us?
He's not dead. I think he's just...
I'm taking notes.
Taking notes. Oh, alright, okay. This is good. Notes are good.
Part of the thing. Okay, I begrudgingly
How effective are those notes sitting in the room?
Well, I get to explore these bodies you so neat, you know, nicely dragged over to me.
Alright, this door, as you approach it, Kellen being the first one there, it is locked.
I look at Mateo and go, you want to do the thing you did it before?
Mateo, do that thing you do.
You make me want to sing right now and I can't break character. Alright, so I will do...
So this is a dex check, and then if you have thieves tools, you can add your proficiency of +2.
If you go into your character sheet, it's already
I do
there.
Have thieves tools. Yeah, I do have thieves tools.
Well, if you go to your...
I have Thunderwave.
Yeah, I have Thunder. That may become handy later.
Go to skills, and under investigation is lockpick. I put it in there for you in the custom ones.
Oh, well done. Well done.
Sweet.
Okay, you keep moving everything. You're freaking me out of my own screen.
I have it on the screen that you need to see.
I see it.
Alright, so I need to do...
Just click the roll button next to lockpick. That's it.
I mean, I could do it.
Oh, there it is. I got it. Okay.
There we go. That's good.
Okay.
You run your pick into the lock, trying to just real precise. Ding, 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 ding. The door swings open. Let me go back to my reveal tool. From that position, you see just a little bit of the room, and it continues on. Can't quite see the whole room yet. See about half of it, or what you can interpret. All right,
well, I'm gonna look to the corner and just see what I can see around.
One moment.
So, Mateo and Eladrin, are you guys doing the Scooby-Doo peek around the corner?
Oh, yeah.
Kellen, you went forward first. You take 2 points of damage from this blade trap that shoots out of the wall.
Yay!
Yes. I am not the trap monger.
Those are some deck saves.
Nope. It's just a simple little blade trap. You don't need no deck saves.
It's not like it's gonna kill you.
It's a 1d4. Typically traps are 10, but...
Where is the trap? Is it the door?
If you move your tokens, you'll see is that nice little blood trail under your feet.
Oh, yeah. See it?
Oh.
There you go.
Well, then. That's already done.
No one's passive perception was high enough to catch the trail.
All right.
Okay. Yeah, you see the whole room now. And you see...
Three corpses. Oh, geez.
So,
hey there, guys.
Akka's gonna kind of walk around the corner and go, yep, see? Told you. They're here.
I'm gonna do a perception check while we're in here, then.
Okay, sure.
I'm gonna start poking shit with my spear, making sure it's not a...
not a mimic.
Yeah, not a mimic.
Didn't the Jackaware run this way when we chased it?
He tried
it
to.
It was running.
Oh no! It was running towards the room.
Toward the room, and you can now kind of guess, it was trying to get to the secret passage, to maybe hide before you guys got vision of it.
Yeah, but the third one got away, didn't it?
No.
No, he got it with a shot.
Yeah,
and Kellen was preventing. Kellen got in front. And was blocking the door, preventing it from escaping. And then while he was doing that, the creature was distracted, and Mateo got a kill shot. Okay.
I take my perception did not work.
Well, while being low, you just look through the bodies, and you discover
Look at this. That
or we could go with Bechdel's perception.
You discover this.
Impossible. Another group of three adventurers found this temple before us. I was reaching to pull out my blade when the dark-haired one insisted we just talk and not fight. After some conversation, we discovered they were archaeologists just seeking scrolls, scripts, and other clues about the creators of the temple and the cult of Devedra. When it seemed like each of our parties had different goals, Thana casually blurted out about the orb. They seemed to have no interest in the orb, but instead offered to aid us on their quest. Right now, they're leading us to a storeroom. The brown-haired one went in front and is disabling a couple of traps they set to fortify their area against wandering monsters. I can just make out stacks of crates and barrels. Wow, this is enough supplies to easily last us the rest of our time down here. I'll be sure to then.
Illegible scribbling.
That's what they're high.
You wouldn't just carve ah.
Oh god.
This is a black beast.
You know what I really love the idea that he's writing this note as they're walking into the back.
He was texting while walking.
Yeah.
Oh, he was doing exactly what the car was doing.
Hey.
Writing notes.
His perception was low because of it.
So what happens to the car's hand when we cross streets
I'm taking note of are either dead or about to be dead.
Yeah, how's that treating you?
It's pretty good.
Okay.
All right.
As he takes note of Bechdel.
Is it okay if I step up here and start poking stuff with my spear?
Did Bechdel find anything else with his perception?
Yeah, Bechdel, you're the first to notice of
thing.
You're the first to notice on. All right. First off, I'll ping him.
Yeah, I guess since he's going first.
If the game will let me ping him. No, it's fine. Yeah, I don't matter. This guy's a fighter. This guy was the bard. This was Husam. And this one was a druid. This was Thana.
Thank you for the follow, Tonebone.
So, on the fighter, Habib, you find
two hand crossbows.
Elven, God's willing.
I'm glad that it took a 20 in perception to figure out that the one with the shield was a fighter and the one with boobs was a female.
I said that was the druid, eh? There are... God, I'm so bad. Oh, I did the wrong roll. God damn it.
15,000 gold pieces?
Because I lost some of my notes, I gotta roll the treasure table again. There we go.
I remember what it was. It was a
magical pair of wrist wraps. All right. There's 90 gold pieces.
Writing it down.
Yeah, someone write this down because I'm busy.
I'm putting this in just kind of a general fund, by the way, guys. Separate.
From that's special.
That way we can divvy it out later.
And a pearl... Or several pearls. Six pearls, each worth, I think it's 50 GP apiece. Let me look at that.
Are they strung together? If so, I look at them curiously.
Do we have any more rings of water walking?
They're single. And you already have a ring of water walking.
You said six pearls?
Six pearls, so there's one for each of you, 50 GP apiece.
I give mine to the merchant for now.
Like I said, let me hang on to them, folks.
And
divvy everybody's allowance out later.
I tried to barter. That ended up horrible, as you can see with all my ones.
Got some serious Will Wheaton rolls.
Oh, yeah, man. Morning. I'm putting him to shame right now. Oh, monk? Dex check? No, I fall face first.
All right. Also, on the... Shoot. The bard. You find this vial of like sticky black unguents. You can't quite tell what it is.
All right, I'm gonna do a arcana check.
I'm gonna do a nature check.
If figure out what it is. Hopefully your nature recognizes it.
Can I use
it.
My herbalism kit to do a better, like a plus 2 to my nature check?
Yes, you can.
I need to put that in here. Okay, so 12.
Alright. This is oil of slipperiness. The sticky black unguent is thick and heavy in the container, but it flows quickly when poured. The oil can cover a medium or smaller creature, along with the equipment it's wearing and carrying. One additional vial is required for each size category above medium, but all you guys are at least medium. Applying the oil takes 10 minutes. The affected creature then gains the effect of a freedom of movement spell for 8 hours. So you can look that up in your PHB.
So we found lube.
Yup.
You found lube.
I don't want to be the one to say it. There's 3 of them in a room, and there's...
That's why I asked if the pearls were strung together.
Welcome to D&D.
This is how to D&D, everyone. Your Twitch stream is going to get shut down.
No, my Twitch stream has always been like this. Everybody I stream with has always been like this.
Also, one more thing on the fighter is a +1 shield.
Ooh.
So Akka's going to pick that up, give it a little flip over, and be like, yeah, that's useless. And chuck it over at Kellen.
Okay.
And like, brings Kellen to the wall.
So, Kellen, when you can just mark that in your inventory, when you use your shield, you have an additional +1 to AC.
Alright. Quick question, completely out of everything else. Jeweler's tools, would that just be what role would that be?
Let's say intelligence.
Okay. Alright, thank you.
Alright.
So that's everything off of them?
Yeah, that seems to be it. You get the feeling that they didn't come in here with much loot on them, actually. This hoard that you found is what came out of that treasure chest that was empty by the bed. They found it first, pocketed it, and then that's all they found, because then they ran into the jackalwares.
And there's nothing else in this room, right? That we could tell?
Nope.
Alright. And in the boxes of stuff, is just food and water type supplies?
Food and water and supplies, yeah. Which you guys don't necessarily need. You have plenty.
How long would it take me to make jewelry?
It would take at least a long rest, and even then that jewelry may not be exquisite because you're doing it by hand with your tools instead of with any kind of...
I have a jeweler's kit.
Okay.
So, since I'm having a little forgetful memory, are these doors over here out to the left?
Where? Oh, yes.
This is a door, and this is a door.
Yep. I'll take those pearls for now until we figure out last week what I can make with them to make them more valuable.
Okay.
Okay.
Interesting. All right. That's a cool idea.
Write them down.
While we're standing here, I'm going to suggest that we go back to the other room that had the statues in it and continue exploring there, kind of, finish out everything.
Also, because I don't think anyone wrote it down when you got from the mimic. I mean, he had the ring and he had a couple healing potions. There was one orange potion.
Oh, I don't remember that at all.
I remember that, but I don't think we wrote it down.
Arcana?
Exactly. So please write that down. Yeah, go ahead.
Also, when we're looking at it, yeah.
I had looked through the VOD and I remember saying it, and I checked people's sheets and I'm like, I don't see this listed.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna be nice because I like you guys using tools. This is a potion of fire breath.
Ooh.
I hand this to the dragonborn.
What? But he already does it.
He already does fire. He does breathing.
Who do you think is going to be better at aiming fire breath? The guy who does it normally or one of you guys who are new at it?
The guy that surfs on tables.
Yeah, because that worked out so well last time.
Also, from such a high arcana check, this is not just like a single use. The effect lasts for 1 hour, or it lasts for 3 different breaths.
Huh. Interesting. But yeah, I will not hold on to that. I will hand that to one of our frontliners. So,
I'll give it to Kellen.
Okay.
Yeah, if anybody's going to be face-to-face with anybody, it'll be Kellen.
Well, face-to-face like and effect.
For how much of a range does it have?
It's usually a cone.
It's a 30-foot cone.
Okay.
So 30 feet long and then 30 feet wide at 30 feet out. So that's, 30 feet?
That's correct.
Holy crap. So that's, 6 squares back and 6 squares wide at the end.
That's kind of crazy.
Yeah, to give you an idea.
This one's not a cone, actually. This is a single breath. It says, at a target within 30 feet of you.
Oh, okay.
So this is a single breath, like a...
You got fire spit, bro.
You got fire spit.
Sweet. So, do we want to move back to the statues over here, then? And kind of explore these 2 rooms?
That sounds like a decent idea before we head out to the either the cave or the, lower level that had blood in it.
Yeah. I mean, I'd vote just because to kind of finish everything off before we move, and who knows what'll happen in the cave.
Yep. All right. Akka will take, kind of a rear point position, so following you guys.
All right. Let me just see which direction y'all head. You're going over... to the room with the statues by it?
Correct.
Yes.
Following the path that we know is safe and clear of traps.
Sorry about that. I had to grab a bottle of water and figure out what's going on with my father.
Alright.
These statues, though.
These statues.
I'm finally just going to poke one. I'm over it. I'm going to start shoving it sideways.
Yep, I move back.
Don't cover the door.
Don't cover shove it the other way.
Some of you didn't put your passive perceptions in your name like I asked. So only Akamanos and Dakar hear this. Akamanos is still behind. Akamanos, you see behind the door?
Well, I mean, they're open doors, aren't they?
Yeah, they are. All right. Akamanos and Dakar, you hear from... the room on the other, the room to the north. You hear a number of hissing sounds, multiple hisses.
All right.
Intelligent, do not.
Where do I put that passive perception?
Yeah. If you go into settings, with the gear and display name, change that to your name dash per whatever the number is.
Yeah, make it your actual name.
Save name.
Because okay, then I can just look at it right here and know, all right, sweet, did they find out? Yes, no. It's really helpful.
I did it, but it didn't change my token's name.
No, your token's not supposed your character.
To. Okay.
It's down at the bottom.
Is that in the display name?
Correct.
Change it to what?
Like everybody else's, if you look at the bottom. So, mine is a Commodos-PER12.
Oh, P-E-R.
I mean, you can, not put the hyphen in, and whatever. It'll be fairly clear. So we hear a whole bunch of snakes. I'm going to tell Eldred, hold that thought, and I'm actually going to look at Dakar. I've seen Dakar cast Burning Hands before, haven't I?
I'm pretty sure you have.
Yeah, I believe so, yes.
Okay. Oh, yeah, because you threw the, sheet over the guy. I'm going to beckon Dakar over, because if there's a whole bunch of little snakes in here, we're just going to fry them.
Okay.
Is the door locked or no?
The door is locked. Open. This door is locked.
Which door was it? The north door?
I'm going to step up and I'm going to ask, do you guys want me to hold this potion since I'm going to be unlocking it and might unlock it in my face, or you want me to unlock it and hop out of the way?
Honestly, I'm not quite sure. At this range, standing right there when we let loose any kind of, wavy hand magic stuff, that's a really bad place to be. Right.
But I have to be here to unlock the door.
Yeah. So I would honestly say, Kellen, go ahead and step back so there's a place for Mateo to move to and we'll see what happens. But
well, could Dakar go right behind me here, and then I can go where Dakar was once I unlock it, so that way he has a straight shot at the door?
So here's my thinking. They're snakes. They don't have arms. You just need to unlock it. That's all you got to do. We'll burst open the door and then set loose our fire.
Oh,
we don't have
sure.
to open it. We can do it whenever all we're right, ready.
So I'm just going to unlock it and not open it.
Okay.
So I need to do a... Which check is it again? Oh, that's
lock
right.
Picking.
I have to put it up. Yep, I know. Yeah. There it is.
You need help. This door's kind of locked pretty good. I mean, you
what
can
are
try
we
again.
To help him?
You want me to try again?
Or just say, I'm helping, and then
okay,
you can
since,
do a dex.
Would anyone like to inspire
I'm
me?
I'm helping. Well, no, don't waste that. I'm helping. So a dex check?
There, hold on. I tried again.
All right. Okay. Essentially, helping is like, all right, I'll do the check with you, and you get advantage.
Okay. So, well, you got a 24, then.
Yeah, so Eladrin is like helping you listen for the tumblers, and then this time he's like, "All right, yes, that one. Think, that one. Think, that one. Think." The door opens up.
I think he was just unlocking
it.
He's just unlocking it.
Oh, okay, fine. Unlocked. The door is now unlocked.
Eldrin, right. Could you move so I could get out of here?
You can get out. You're good.
Just kidding. The other way, all right, I prepare but do not actually cast Frozen Hands and kind of, like, point. Because if there's a whole bunch of snakes, we're just going to torch them.
I get right here and have my spear readied.
Ready?
Yep.
Let's do this.
Okay, so in one action, I'm going to open the door, swing it open, and then let loose with my free hand, Burning Hands, in a cone directly in front of me.
Oh, all right, so you're going
to
have Burning
Look,
Hands.
Sure, we don't want you to open it, because what if there's something that's useful and then we burn it?
Yeah, I was going
to
say, don't Burning Hands just yet.
Well, should I open
have,
it and dodge
have,
out the way?
You want to have Burning
have
Hands
burning
ready?
Burning Hands readied as an action as soon as you open the door.
Right.
Of course, after you see what is within there. You're not going to be stupid and just close your eyes and Burning Hands.
I really want to, though.
Okay. It'd be great roleplay.
Do it.
For the sake of knowledge and preserving whatever creatures might be on the other side so that I can keep a record for this,
I will
choose not to set everything on fire, but instead I will gently open the door with my burning hands prepared.
Okay. With burning hands prepared, you open the door.
And I will step inside one square.
You open the door.
Sure, we don't want a perception check. Oh,
into wait. Some oh. kind of torturing going on. You see this little halfling laying on a table with a number of snakes surrounding her, and then there are these two figures that look perfectly humanoid, kinda, except their arms are literal snakes that just slither out from them.
I'm just laughing because the halfling doesn't fit on the damn table.
yeah.
So,
and through all this, you hear this dark kind of chanting. Isa, Othanmara, Isa.
So, interrupt that.
Yeah.
Is the halfling on the table conscious or like alive? Like, is she in
this business? Halfling is screaming for her life.
So yeah, she's like
how we heard the hissing of the snakes,
but
not
the
screaming.
We become accustomed to it.
All right. DM error. Sorry.
That's fine.
But yeah.
So
I'm kind of glad we didn't flame the room.
She looks over, and she sees you. They see her eyes dart.
Thanks for
and
giving
now,
us a light.
The two Wanti. Look into your direction.
Well, our
Burning Hands is readied. Everybody roll initiative.
That's not a cone, is it?
It can. It can originate from any corner.
Oh, okay.
Are Mateo and Eldrin still stealthed or no?
I would say step forward one more and cast and get three of them.
Roll additional stealth checks right now. Mateo, you might be back far enough. They're blocking the door. Eladrin, roll a stealth check.
Yeah, I should have.
I I found a mimic in the top right corner.
Is everything a mimic now?
Mimic has been proven otherwise.
My initiative didn't roll. Why did I
click on your token?
Probably because, yeah.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Jeez.
Same thing for the card.
Glad I have a high plus to freaking initiative.
Wait, why does my initiative? Oh.
You need to click on your token so it's highlighted, and then click the initiative button.
Okay, there we go.
There you go.
It's much better than a one.
Shh.
But it would make sense.
I was just trying to like roll for myself.
What was that?
That's not good.
I'm sorry, Eladrin. You rolled a nat 20 on perception.
Oh.
So, I see you hiding in the shadows. So, you're not stealth.
And I see you spitting everywhere when you talk.
They may be, but I'm not.
No, that's what I meant, them. I say that back. I literally say that back.
Does real quick question, it's going to make a difference in what I do. Is Dakar able to get that flame off real quick in front of him or no?
It is prepared, but yeah. I didn't roll initiative well enough.
No, because
it's prepared. It happens before.
Yeah.
All right. I'm going to Dewan T will move separately, but the snakes will move in groups.
Well, he needs to roll the damage for the hands if he's going to... He had it prepared, remember?
Uh-huh.
It makes a difference for Mateo.
I'm slow with my initiative rolls.
Oh, no, that's fine. I'm saying while you're doing initiative, he could roll the damage.
Question for clarification on Colossus Strike. Is it per creature or per turn?
Per turn.
Per turn.
So each creature hit by it could take extra damage, correct? Or hit?
Every turn you shoot, and in their damage, you can do it.
Right, but if I did an area of effect spell on things that are all damaged, does it apply to each?
No. Plain and simple, it says you can deal this extra damage only once per turn, not once per character or anything like that.
And you wouldn't be able to do both. You wouldn't be able to do... They're both bonus actions to do it.
No, Colossus Slayer isn't. Colossus is just...
Is it really?
It happens. Yes.
Holy
crap. Yes, it's broken.
Not at all.
Can I have Colossal Slayer fists?
No.
But you'll only be able to do that with, because it's when you hit a creature.
Hello.
You do that 1d8. You can only do that once.
So you would choose which creature.
Multiple creatures?
Right.
Okay. You would choose which creature.
Okay.
It's like an aimed shot. You're not gonna aim shot a crowd.
Yeah, it's pretty good way to put that.
I need to make this turn order larger. Some stuff I just didn't have as ready. I had the story ready, but of course
Holy
I didn't have the combat
crap,
ready.
Like I'm just continuously stretching this thing to fit it on the screen.
I wouldn't worry about stretching it too far since, you know, it's just going to move automatically anyways.
Well, I want people to see how much is going on.
Right.
Alright. Now I'm ordering people.
You should just be able to right-click and tell it to sort.
Oh.
Or there's a gear settings thing that can just tell it to sort.
Yeah. Bechtel, what's your dex? Oh, wait, your dex is going to be decent. Bechtel?
Yeah, I got to pull it up. Hang on.
Uh-huh.
So, 14.
All right, you will go ahead of... The Yuan-Ti. That's another thing. When I put in the nameplates, you guys see the nameplates. But whatever. And then last roll for that creature. My book.
Can I tell which one of the Yuan-Ti... Or no, that's a snake. Okay, that's a snake.
Those look like snakes.
Yeah, we saw how easily the constrictor snakes melt before. We've seen them. It's the Yuan-Ti we have to worry about.
Yeah.
I mean, if they shoot arrows at us, it'll go better, and then I'm going to roll ones and drop it.
Alright. Now we're about ready.
SGM, what level are you casting Burning Hands at?
Second level.
Sweet.
This thing is prepared.
It was.
Uh-oh.
There's the music.
Alright. Top of the round, Dakar has a Burning Hands prepared. A Burning Hands lances out from his fingertips, igniting one of the snakes and the Malison. Holy balls.
Someone, the info blocking was checked for some reason.
Well, yes. It's got some of your turn undead stuff in there as well, like as your class action. Disable that. That's weird.
No,
anyway, Burning Hands. I have to do a dex save.
For two of them.
Wouldn't it be three? Wouldn't it be...
No, it's only two that's hitting.
Yeah, the one... Yeah.
Oh.
Oh,
wait,
actually,
15.
5, 10, 15. Oh,
no,
wait,
it's originating from me.
Right.
So it would only hit the snake and then the wanty in front.
Yep. Okay, 12 damage if they don't save. 6 if they do. Wait, hang on. Roll an extra d6, SGM, because that only did the 3d6.
Nice.
Sweet, so another 4, so 16 damage.
Yeah, that's another thing with the spell tools I was mentioning to you. There was one that when you click the spell, then it's like, okay, what level you want to cast it?
Nice.
Yeah, all right, so. And roll for the little snake. The little snake makes the save and takes half damage. The Malison does not and takes full damage.
Yes!
Little snake takes 8, big snake takes
wait,
16.
Wait, what the fuck am I doing? Oh. Hold on, there's something I forgot.
Foul language, cover your ears!
Sorry, kiddos.
I'm just kidding.
Alright, the Malison takes full damage. The damage is 12.
I don't think my stream
is 16.
The damage is 16.
I don't think my stream is listed as family friendly, don't worry.
The snake takes half damage and goes to that. I can't even see it because of this thing's nameplate, so I'm going to take that off. I like seeing the health bars. It allows me to get a feel.
Speaking of which, Dakar, since you weren't here last week, and I don't know if you watched the VOD, this would probably be the part where you would do a perception check to try and check the health of some of the stuff.
Yes, this is a new rule we have. You can, as just a free action, make a perception check to see the health bars of creatures. Essentially, it's just you judging the creature, seeing what your impact did. The reason I have this rule in is so our lovely stream viewers can see what the monsters are at.
Alright. I'll go do that right now.
Alright. With that, you easily get both of them.
Oh man, that's beautiful.
Boom.
Okay.
Alright.
At the top of the round is Mateo.
All right. I can move through our people, right?
As difficult terrain, but you can shoot through us with no problem.
Yeah, to move through everyone, that's going to cause double movement because everyone's squished in this corridor.
So I'm going to move here then.
You're going to have a line of sight. Okay, sure.
And then, sorry, one second. I've been trying to decide what I want to do here. Can I do both a Hunter's Mark and another spell in one round or no?
Hunter's Mark is a bonus action.
Hunter's Mark is also a bonus.
No, you cannot.
Hunter's Mark is a bonus. And so you could do a cantrip, but I don't think you even have cantrips.
No. I was going to say, I was going to ask if I could Hunter's Mark and then Hail of Thorns, but...
No.
Alright, so then I will go... I will Hunter's Mark this guy. I don't think I can choose him to.
No,
you
can't.
You have to put it. Yeah.
You should be able to. But here,
no,
I got
can't
it.
Select
no, he means put a token on it. Yeah.
Yeah.
I love the.
Okay, and then. I will do a normal attack with my longbow.
Bring it.
All right, let me find it real quick. Sorry. Wait, should I use silver or should I use just regular longbow?
Regular arrows. Don't need silver on these guys. Nice.
Holy balls, those rolls.
Sadly, not actually a crit.
Yeah, I know it's not a crit. Alright, it takes 9 piercing damage.
Plus?
Plus a 1d6.
Plus a 1d8.
I know. I was already on top of that.
Matt, just do slash roll 1d6.
Plus
1d8.
That.
So, slash roll.
But you gave them more
1d6.
HP.
1d6.
I did.
Do I need a space plus or just
plus.
Plus, like plus. Right after the 6 and then 1d8.
There you go. Nice.
God, mother of lord. He's hurting pretty bad.
Yeah, that was what, 21 damage right there? No, 22 damage. 22.
Gosh. Rangers. That is literally broken.
I guess that's my turn.
All right.
You do have more movement if you want to move into a different position.
No, because this... I guess I get out of the way in case Bechtold wants to move, so I'll get out of Bechtold's way.
Nope, move back. That's where I'm going.
All right! I will stay where I am because Bechtold told me not to move. I'm good.
I don't know why you guys put the healer in the front.
It's his icon. It's intimidating.
Yeah. That beard and that pink hair. Wait, purple hair?
Look at those eyes. Look at those eyes. That stare.
I imagine that if this was a movie, he would be played by Sean Connery.
I was getting more of a Liam Neeson kind of vibe.
Not cool enough for Liam Neeson.
Well, this snake will move over and snap at the healer.
Oh, joy.
We get to its...
Who stat. Does have a brand new shield with a +1 on it.
I have that.
Yeah, that's Kellen's.
So sorry.
Nice try.
Toss it up.
Oh, jeez.
22 versus armor class.
Yeah.
Quick, warding flame.
17.
Yeah, you can't use your reaction.
Yep. Make him roll at disadvantage.
Yes, he can. He does have warding flame.
Where?
Are you gonna...
You don't have to roll anything. You just decide to do it.
Yeah, let me know that you're doing it. Yes? Do you know what warding flame is?
I will just take the hit. It's fine.
Okay. Okay. Now give me a constitution saving throw.
Oh, jeez. Of all the...
Yeah, they're spiders.
No, they're not.
All right, spiders, you, snakes. You feel the poison coursing through your veins, and you shrug it off. But from the snake's bite, you take 6 points of piercing damage.
Spider snakes sounds terrifying.
And now this other snake will come around.
Oh yeah, they all move at once.
To attack the healer. If you warding flame here, I'll be nice and tell you it doesn't matter because it is flanking.
So, yeah.
I'll just take it. Con roll again. Con.
Let me do my regular damage first. Yes, roll the Constitution saving throw.
Oh, so close.
You feel the poison again trying to go through you, and you shrug it off. Oh. But you take an additional 8 points of piercing damage. I don't know why you guys put the healer in the front. The snake will slither on over and make an attack with flanking.
Technically, he doesn't have flame.
Technically, I know the statue, but like he's surrounded by two other snakes that are snapping at him.
Flanking, I really should have shot that snake, shouldn't I?
This is an advantage attack. Yeah. It might still miss, but this is definitely an advantage attack. I should have just rolled those together.
Yeah.
So that is 19 against armor class.
17, that hits.
All right, rolling damage.
Oh my god.
Put the healer in the front. This is what you get.
Oh, he's fine.
Yeah, I'm totally.
All fine. Right, roll me a Constitution saving throw.
I don't think that one's gonna do it.
You feel the poison coursing through your veins, and you shrug it off.
Again.
This is weak poison.
And this time, you only take 4 points of piercing damage. But there's still one more snake. Let me see if he can get to you. You'd have to like go over the table. That's double movement. 10, and snakes are tiny, so they can't move. Oh, wait, they can. 10, 15,
You can move over the table?
It's not movement for going through.
Here's what, 10, 15, 5.
Yeah.
One more attack, coming your way with advantage.
I'm just face tanking you this.
That's all right.
You might be able to survive this one. Does a 14 hit your armor class?
17.
No. After getting bitten by several snakes, Takar deftly dodges this next one.
Learning.
But how are those notes working, buddy?
He looks in some rough shape. Kellen.
How do I even get in here?
The movement is gonna be weird. It'll cost you 2 spaces to get through Akka, and 2 spaces to get through Dakar. You could swing at a snake like as you're going through Dakar, and then if you kill the snake, you can end up in its spot.
Actually, are they tiny?
These are medium. These are giant poisonous snakes.
So, out of character, how best can I? I don't think I can do anything to move the car back in, like, back away from
the shield
snakes.
I don't think so. You would have to just shield him or at least kill those snakes before their next turn.
Or hold your turn till after his.
Actually, that's not a bad idea considering Dakar goes next.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll do that. I'll hold my turn until after Dakar.
Okay. I don't think you can just like hold as you want. You have to declare a circumstance. So after Dakar has used his movement and cleared the path, you will go. You're delaying essentially.
Yes.
Okay.
That's what I want to do.
Okay. Cool. Killing delays. I will just slide you down here. Dakar, your go. You've taken multiple snake bites. Thankfully, you have resisted the poison that would more than likely have killed you, but you're feeling it was not wise to go in first.
Wait a minute. Hold up. Where are my bed sheets?
Oh, dude, use your crazy crap.
Your crazy
crap. Your disco ball. What the heck is it called?
My bag of glowing.
His channel divinity?
Yes, well, that one.
His best bet would be to use his action to. What's it called?
No, dude. Radiance of Dawn, 2d10 damage to everything in the room.
That's correct.
Would that also be to the halfling, though?
No, because it's hostile creatures.
Okay.
That is also correct.
Just wanted to make sure. So that might be his best bet, and then haul out of the room to the back of the line.
What if the halfling in the room is actually kind of a bitch?
Then we don't need to.
You don't really know yet, do you?
We will find out.
Yeah, we'll find
out. You know what? Great test.
Yeah, this is a good way to figure that out.
So, what is your action?
I don't have a list, so I'm looking for it right now in my book.
Radiance. If you want to use Radiance of the Dawn, as Akka and some others have suggested. I put it, I believe, in your class features.
Class feature.
Also, on the player's handbook, it is page 61.
Channel Divinity Radius of the Dawn. Okay, I see that, and oh, there it is. On action, you present a holy symbol of magical darkness 30 feet of dispel. Each hostile creature within.
By the way, I have not upped the HP of any of these snakes. They're using their average HP.
Creature that has total cover from you is not affected.
None of these creatures have total cover.
That would right, be.
These behind guys are huge, and these guys can clearly see you.
All right, we're going. Channel Divinity.
Cool. So roll 2d10 plus 4.
First, roleplay this mess. You have just been bitten by multiple snakes, you're feeling at dire straits, and you call out to Malil.
I whip out my holy symbol, and I'm gonna utter some explicatives against these creatures. I am sick of all these motherfucking snakes in this motherfucking
on
room.
This material plane.
And I cast. Nice.
Holy shit. Constitution saving throws. I need to do these in secret. What happens if they
half damage
on a, half as much on a fail? All right, I'm gonna start using some markers. You guys obviously don't know what the markers mean.
Well, it's full damage on a fail, half on a successful, right?
Yes.
Correct.
What the? Oh. Because there is no quick way to roll this. This is the fun with area attacks.
You don't even press up to repeat.
That's what I'm doing.
Right? Okay.
Also, the DC is 8 plus your cast. What is your DC for your other spells? Just go look for me, please.
Which should have gone up by his level, too, right?
Yeah, it'll be under your spell book.
It may not have gone up by his level. Oh,
it does.
It does.
If he selected Wisdom as his stat, it does. You guys haven't gotten a proficiency bonus yet. That comes at level 5.
No, but you
Wisdom
get your...
is a bonus for me, though. Or I am proficient.
Just whatever is listed as his spell DC. 14. It's going to be in spells.
He said 14.
Spellbook. For cleric, save DC is 13.
Told you guys it doesn't go up.
Really? I thought it wouldn't.
No, eight plus
proficiency plus level, right?
Plus, no. Plus proficiency plus modifier. So the proficiency is 2. His modifier is 3. 13 is correct. All right. I think I got all of them. Now I need to get. This is a long ass.
And don't forget to roll process. Perception.
Oh, yeah.
You'll see the perception in a bit.
No, I meant that for the health for him.
I see numbers. What's going on?
So many numbers. Yeah. Now the last two. See, this is why I'm gonna eventually get pro and I can set groups and do things properly. I could just do the same one. All right. After a buttload of rolls, anything listed with a red marker failed the DC and take 17 points of damage. You see this snake completely explode. You see this guy get hit pretty hard, and you can make a perception check in a sec. Actually, screw it. You see this guy get hit pretty hard. This snake explodes. Half of 17, rounded down, is 8. This snake that already got hit by the burning hands explodes. And I say explodes because, like, just this divine energy emanates from Dakar and from his symbol. And those that can't resist it just get completely blown to smithereens.
This is sort of like seeing a vampire in light. They just, like, burst into dust.
It's like, ah.
Not only have I been bitten by these giant snakes, now I'm covered in their...
Wow. And that's why you can only use that, like...
Once a day.
Once, I think. Once a day.
Short rest.
Is it really?
Is it?
It really can't be short rest for Channel Divinity.
Battery's got multiple uses per long rest. One of the two.
He has multiple uses, but I'm pretty sure you can only invoke...
Yep, you must finish a short or long rest to use your Channel Divinity again.
Oh my god.
The holy fuck.
Literally.
Well then.
He is a holy fuck.
All right, guys. Rangers being broken?
Yeah. Dakar and I got this dungeon. If you guys could just come back when we're done.
I'm just going to start messing around with the statue, I guess.
Okay.
I feel like
a whole bunch of stuff happened. A number of creatures exploded. Dakar, you still have movement actions.
I can't really move, or else I'll trigger attacks of opportunity from those two.
Yes.
Yeah.
Actually, in point of case, I would suggest you go ahead and do it, because there's only going to be two attacks, and you could actually use your reaction to put one at disadvantage.
Yeah, but he's already really low health, and we have a couple of people to go. Yeah, Kellen.
Kellen can get through now. Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
No, that'll be all. I won't risk it.
Okay.
Can I ask a question real quick? Those what? Two, I noticed one, the one to the left, the snake guys, did he took 22 plus whatever, and he's got more health than the one that took 17? Or about the same health?
Yeah,
they're pretty close. They're pretty close in health right now.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, but the one on the right took 17 damage and he's that low, and the other one took 22 plus, I don't even know where the
plus
rest of it is.
Damage, yeah.
Plus 22 plus 8, so 30.
Wait, I think I might have taken a little
extra. It's 22 plus
off.
8, which is 30.
No, I think I had bad math. Okay.
I'm just curious.
Yeah, the one on the left should be have 30 minutes missing.
Yeah, the one on the left... You can see, like, their max value, too? Shit, that's a little broken.
Well, we see a percentage of their
health. No, I'm saying it should have 30 off of its health. Actually, more than that.
30 points.
No, more than that, because the,
You have not hit this one on the right, except with that big blast, which is not hit.
Correct.
One on the left's been hit 3 times.
That's why I was just confused. I just wanted to make sure, since we can see their health bars, I was a little... Because I did 22 points of damage.
I think I did something wrong. Math. Math, how do you work?
Did the one on the left save from the burning hands before, or no?
There. He's the one on the left is at the accurate HP. The one on the right is now at accurate HP.
Okay. And... okay, that makes more sense. Not that I really wanted him to have more HP, but I was just a little confused.
Okay.
Should have kept my
mouth shut. Turn is complete.
Should have.
Kellen.
Okay.
You can't get in the room. Two movement to go past Akka, two to go past the car. And stand then you can, like, stand on a snake corpse.
All right, then. And...
two, four, five. Okay, good.
Yeah. I'm going to just kill this one. Or hopefully kill it. I don't know. We'll see. So, weapons. And I am two-handing my sword, so...
Do we know the health bars of those two, or no? We can't see them. We didn't perception them.
I mean, he may or may not just kill it. So. I just need to start showing the health bars on all of them. I just don't want you guys metagame. I just don't want you guys metagaming too much.
Does walking on the corpse of a large creature?
No.
Any difficult terrain?
No, it's dust. Anyways, remember it died to the divine light.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, also, these are giant snakes, but their size is medium. That's why they only occupy one square. So Kellen swings at this thing, and it just kind of slithers beneath his blade and hisses at him.
Oh.
That'll be all right.
Okay, then. And as a bonus action, I take out my shield. I'm holding now one-handed sword and a shield.
Sword and board. Kellen's AC goes up to 19 because he's got a plus one shield. Okay.
And that's it for me.
This snake is going to slither around. Actually, it's a big snake. You'll probably just slither right over, no problem. And it is going to attempt... what, really? There we go, that's the one I want. It is going to attempt to constrict you, Kellen.
Alright.
It's no big deal.
Do I need to make some kind of saving throw to this?
No, this is against armor class.
Okay.
So you see this giant thing coming, you just kind of beat it away with your shield. And that's all it could do. Eladrin!
I'm going to squeeze through and go up to...
one, three, five... what the? How many squares can you move? I know 40. You move a lot. 40. All right, let me show you.
5, 10.
I don't know if you can see that. So it's 5, and then it's... all right, it's 10 to go through Akka and 10 to go through Dakar. It's 20 total to get past them. So you're already taking 25 by standing on Dakar. 30, 35. Okay, yeah, you're fine.
Yeah, he can get there in 40.
Freaking monks.
Monks and barbarians, bro.
Oh, man, you should see my shadow monk. I could just fucking teleport there and still have
that's
my full
movement.
That's
what he's gonna do before too much longer.
I'm gonna try.
He's just not really adept at riding tables.
Yeah, no. Alright, I'm gonna try and take out this. Whatever the hell this thing is.
So you want tea with snake arms! Snakey.
What's some, like, really useless arms? Like, how does he hold
it? It looks like he has boxing gloves on.
I don't know if that was...
don't compare the model to the...
yeah, so just 11
damage.
Yeah,
don't compare the model. Yeah, the model is just what I can find. Alright. 11 points of damage. And here comes the extra.
Or not.
I'm actually
the extra... what?
Key point?
What?
Yeah, I'm gonna use a key point and do 2 attacks.
There you go.
Alright, second one hits.
Roundhouse kick his head off.
Is that sucker still alive?
He's barely standing.
Wow.
Man, if I had hit with that other one.
Yep.
I want him to get his turn, damn it.
No, please no.
The other one will get a turn.
Yeah.
No, it's alright.
I want them both to get a turn. Alright, Eldrin's done. Bechtold.
You always pronounce
it. I know. He's weird. Like. It's like a.
Well, it looks German, like Bechtold. Or Bechtold.
Hang on.
All right, while you decide.
Chrome is being slow on me.
You don't want to finish up the one, Yanti?
Alright, I'm gonna cast Shatter right.
Oh dear lord.
Does that hurt the halfling?
There we go.
It might!
I'm not worried about it. I don't care about the halfling. I wasn't here to save the halfling.
You were here to find the disappearing people. Each creature in a 10-foot radius sphere center must make a constitution saving throw. Okay. Shatter. Can you cast a spell so I can see the DC?
Yep, hang on. For whatever reason, pulling up my character sheet, even when it's minimized, roll 20 takes forever.
Yeah, mine's been buggy too.
It's a little laggy.
I'm luckily not having any issues with like my 18 windows open.
Whoa. Hit the little tabs to tag the things.
Yeah, for saving throw and damage.
If he doesn't have it entered right, then
I don't.
It's another thing about that
little
spell.
Tabs for the things. You gotta be more descriptive.
I got it. Description. Saving throw. All right, now cast the spell.
I need attack roll and damage too, right?
No, it's a save. Oh. Oh, the damage should
be. The damage you do need. Not the attack roll. Alright, you can just roll the damage separately if you want now. 3d8. That's not versus AC. Well, you had it listed as an attack roll. And the DC isn't set. Alright, no, you know what? Fuck it. Roll again. I have it set right.
Roll again or click the ability?
Click the ability. There we go. The DC is still not... What the fuck?
It shouldn't be strength.
Saving throw. Oh, it isn't set, I don't think. I got it. DC is con. Save DC.
Bard DC.
On a successful save. Half damage. Anyway, so what's the DC for your spells?
If you just hit bard DC, it fills it in automatically.
I know, but alright, well, I'll cast the damn spell again, but we'll use it on that original damage value. I got it.
There we go.
We're using the original damage value. 15 is your DC?
Yep.
Oh, 'cause you got like 20. Oh, yeah, you got 20. Yeah.
Yeah, Bechtel and I are fabulous fellows.
That's why I said I'm always fresh.
All right, I said the original damage value, so I will roll saves now.
I heard this, Jim.
Well, the one on the left is dead no matter what, then.
Yep.
Yeah, it's wrecked. But what's important is, does the halfling make it safe?
It shouldn't kill it if
not.
It doesn't.
If she does, she'll be mad.
All right. He makes his save.
Okay. You talking about the halfling, or?
No, the creature.
I was gonna say, the halfling looks female to me.
Melisande makes his save. Shatter. What? 10-foot radius sphere.
Half damage, so 5.
Alright. This thing's gonna get blown up as well.
Now, the all-important one. What happens to the halfling? I'm rolling this secret.
Please tell me the halfling explodes.
The halfling... takes half damage and seems disturbed by this shattering sound, but is still alive.
Aww.
Wait, I should make a... shouldn't I? Constitution save as well. We should all
no.
do that.
No, it's a 10-foot radius. Yeah. So
he casted it up there to not, to
he casted
not get
up here.
You guys in it.
Ah, okay. Oh, I didn't see the range on that.
I need to select something.
Can she hear us anymore now?
Yes.
You hear some. You hear some thud, thud, thud. And Kellen's mind briefly goes back to that door that was stuck on the end. Bechtold's turn is over.
Oh, God.
And emerging from the darkness... is a...
Question, were we able to see if that's a hallway on the left? Were we able to see it down to before? Like, when Eldrin moved up, would he not have
here,
been able to
this,
see...
No, this door was stuck.
No, you
and
said
now,
where,
having,
I, where I am.
Oh.
Having heard the dying hissing... Oh, that? Oh, yeah, you can see it on there.
Oh, no.
Oh, snap.
Having heard the dying... hissing screams of its master, this guy on the left, this in like give me option to select things, this giant constrictor snake seemingly takes up almost the entire hallway and snaps at, all right, I'm gonna make a roll, 1 2 3 but 1 2 Akka, 2 3 Bechtol, 1 2 Akka,
just roll it,
3 4 Bechtol, 5 6 Mateo.
Did that six, really Mateo. Land sideways on a digital table?
It yeah, it hit the corner and didn't.
It hit the corner, but then it fixed itself. 6 Mateo. This creature is going to attempt to constrict you. Well, it you can easily tell what it is. This is a giant constrictor snake. At least 30 feet long, if not more.
Ooh, that'll make a nice bag.
Shit.
Guys, we're making a sleeping bag out of that snake.
Who is this we?
Does a 12 hit your armor class?
It doesn't even hit my armor class.
Yeah.
Move along.
Hold on, I'm looking. I'm trying to find it. Sorry.
No.
I don't know where that is on here.
It's on your main
You don't
page.
Even have to look.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, I want to know for future reference.
It
you
hisses
have
15 at you.
AC.
It hisses at you violently.
You oh, now I see it. Okay.
Also, since it, like, bursted that door open, you can see what's in the room, and I'll let you know what that is. You see this.
Ooh, storage.
Why did we not go after that room first?
Because this one made sounds.
This one made sounds and the other one was rusted
This one made
shut.
Sounds earlier the previous night.
Yeah, but it was rusted
So we
shut.
Let the halfling get tortured all night while we slept.
I mean, hey.
Well, no,
we
you don't
fun.
Know. You don't know.
We
you just found
know.
The halfling on the table. There's more to this room.
Yeah, they could have... just grabbed the halfling.
Okay, anyway, its turn is over. Finally, the Malison gets to go. I've been waiting to use this guy.
We tried to deny it, but it didn't work.
I know, I hate you.
We were able to kill one, which is pretty impressive, before it got a chance to even do anything.
Alright, so this Malison... will move around to here and make two attacks on you, Kellen.
Okay.
It swings at you with each of its snake arms. No. It was on a 20!
I know.
I saw all that shit.
No.
So the snakes just glance off your armor. Their fangs trying to seep in through, but no luck. Why am I rolling crappy for all my attacks? I filled this freaking room. Whatever.
Welcome
yeah, it
to
turns
D&D
over
with RNGesus.
Arca.
Question, where can I see my movement?
On that same page that has your armor class, just above it.
Oh, speed? Okay.
Yeah.
And if I forgot to change the level and experience on here,
all
the actual level.
I'm not... level, it will be adjusted by the sheet. XP, I'm not necessarily tracking. As you reach key plot points in the story, you will level up.
Yeah, just
right. No, I know. I'm
no,
just
I'm
making sure
right
I put
now.
It on there.
Class
provided you've done enough stuff to level up. Like level 5, it's gonna take a while because it then triples.
I changed the mat. Go to class and see how you're a level 4 ranger.
Gotcha. Thank you.
Also, there's a show all button, so you guys can display all those tabs at once. Akka, your go.
Yep, just been waiting.
Way too much information.
So I'm going to... probably hex the big guy. He now has disadvantage on strength type of things.
Okay.
And then I'm going to cast...
Wait, you don't have to... There's no kind of save, it
no.
just happens.
It's like Hunter's Mark.
Yeah.
Yep, suck it up. And then...
That's broken.
Yeah, right.
No, Hex is fine-ish.
And... Oh, dude, wait till level 5, then you'll start complaining again. And then I'll cast Eldritch Blast.
I get dirty creatures at level 5.
I just want to point out that the little guys go right after me. So which one are you blasting?
I'm
he's blasting
the
big guy.
One that's right next to you. That would be causing you disadvantage.
Oh, okay. Him.
Yep.
Okay, I was going to ask you. Yeah, right. Okay, good. I like you.
21 versus AC definitely hits. 16 damage.
And then I'm gonna roll perception.
That sweet, sweet Eldritch Blast.
You can already see his bar.
I can't.
No.
I can't.
We can't see the two snakes by Dakar
and
Kellen.
You attack who did you attack? I'm sorry.
The big one that's right next to me.
Yeah. Oh shit. Okay. Let me take this guy back up then. He's up to that amount. You attack the giant snake. It still hits, of course.
Yep, I ain't worried about that.
Alright, perception check. No,
by the
that's
way,
not,
the little
that's
guy.
Not, that's not enough.
Wait, the little guy, I was stealth before. Never mind, doesn't really matter because he missed anyway.
Just, don't worry about that now.
That is not enough. You can't quite tell. You see that you impacted this creature, did some hefty damage, it hisses in retaliation,
cool.
But you're unable to discern the extent of your damage.
And then I'm going to move, move.
If here. You move.
Oh, is he going to attack me?
You provoke an attack of opportunity.
Okay.
Because this thing covers a 3x3.
Oh, I know, I'm familiar. My wife plays a giant constrictor snake as a druid. Hit me, I dare
That's
you.
Right. You said this before. I just had it on my
warlocks
with her snoffus and her snesk.
Yeah, no, yeah. Not warlocks, tieflings.
Oh, that's right.
I don't even have the spell as a warlock. I mean, I don't have it on my spells. No, I do if I wanted it, but you know, my father.
Yeah, it's gonna tip to grab you. 15 versus
that
armor
hits.
Class. All right, you're trying to escape. But this snake...
I'm not really trying to escape. I'm just walking away from it, daring it to hit me.
All right. Yeah, I figured.
Oh, God.
Alright. Well, you take... Wait! I wonder. Let me check something. Given a condition that may or may not happen, I wonder if you could still do that.
It's a reaction.
Yep.
I know, I'm seeing if you can still use reactions.
While being grappled?
It happens. Yeah, if you're talking about being grappled.
Alright, you can still use it. Still use it.
Oh, I'm quite aware.
Yeah, it still happens as a reaction. If it was an action or something like that, it wouldn't happen.
Sweet baby.
Whoa, what are you rolling?
Oh. That's the damage because it hit you. Yeah,
that's fine.
You take 16 points of bludgeoning damage, and you are now grappled by this giant constrictor snake. It is squeezing the literal life out of you, and in doing that, you unleash a hellish rebuke on it. 22! Oh, it's a dex save. Okay, never mind. I was about to go, what the?
Oh my goodness.
Crit one!
No.
Please.
Versus dex. I'm rolling this in secret. It makes the save.
Okay, so it takes 11.
Yep.
Notice he rolls in secret to make the save.
Yeah, yeah.
No, I just roll in secret in general. Like, it takes a little longer.
No, I'm just messing with you.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, and I'm subtracting my temporary hit points. So that's 7. And
you still had those? You had those over
rest?
They resting.
Don't ever go away.
That's interesting. That's not broken. That's just.
How much
I might utilize that on my bard.
It did how much damage? 16?
Yeah.
16 points of bludgeoning damage.
So 9.
So 9 actual damage.
Where are you now, Akka?
Underneath.
It's right.
Underneath isn't fun. I'll say it is grabbing you and put you here. Can't see crap when it's underneath. Akka is getting his life squeezed out of him by this giant constrictor snake. Now, Mateo.
Okay, couple of questions. If it has him in its grasp, if I move, does it still get an attack of opportunity?
It has already used its reaction. Bechtold, Mateo, feel free to move around the country.
Yeah, it has one reaction per turn.
Second question is, does Akka take more damage if, like, we leave him during the duration of the turn in there?
If he does not escape sometimes.
I cannot say.
He can attack me again.
Right, but it would have to be when he gets to his spot, which would be at the end of the...
Yes.
After your turn, correct?
Yes.
Yep.
Okay, just wanted to make sure of that before I do what I'm going to do. I do so much damage, and I don't want to waste it on a little guy, but I want to mitigate what's coming to Dakar.
Don't worry about that.
I'm fine.
You sure?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
You three back there need more help.
Why? All right, I'm going to move. Can I go here and here? Like, I don't know how to make the line, how to do that.
If you drag your token and then you press spacebar while you're dragging, you can start seeing the ruler. You can go kind of anywhere you want, dude. The snake is not provoking opportunity because it has got Akka squeeze and a death grip.
Okay, I can go there, right, since he's ashes?
Yes, absolutely. Yep.
All right, and then I'm going to switch my Hunter's Mark to him. Let me put this on.
Okay.
I will say, because this snake is...
Yeah, you have a snake.
You try to slip past the car, one snake will get an opportunity attack on you, which you can take it. It's just one snake. What do I roll? Get my snake sheet.
Now, my question is, won't he be at disadvantage by trying to shoot past another creature, or are they small?
They're small.
No, so you can shoot past it, right?
They're small enough, rather.
Creatures would have to be larger than them in order to provide cover.
Yeah.
And if I had sharpshooter, it wouldn't have mattered.
Alright, it misses you. Don't worry about it.
Okay, so I'm moving Hunter's Mark to this guy.
Okay.
And I'm going to use my longbow to make an attack.
Okay.
Nice.
No, 1d6 plus 1d8.
Yep, I'm ready for it.
And make sure you mark off arrows when you use them, by the way. Okay, so 17.
17.
I'm going to pull up your character sheet and show you where to do this.
I'm just making little hashes in front of me as I go along for arrows I've used.
Oh, you don't have to do that, Matt. See the page you're on right now that I have you on?
Hold on, I have to... No, it got closed. Hold on. Yeah.
Alright, is your turn done? I'll go ahead and start working these guys.
Yeah, my turn is done, I'm sorry.
Alright. Snakes aren't real smart, so I'm rolling to see who they hit.
To the left of your longbow weapon is ammo. Just click on the down arrow and mark it every time you use it.
Okay.
One snake attacks the car, one snake attacks Eladrin. Nineteen versus armor class to car.
That hits.
Seven points of piercing damage. Unless, like, zero. You have your flare thing if you want to try.
Yeah, sure. I might as well.
Alright, disadvantage. The creature will make another attack roll. And it doesn't matter. The car's limp body slumps to the ground. This snake now crawling all over him. But I'll say, like, actually, I'll say the snake doesn't move, but it's just, it's flavor, okay? And the other snake will snap at Eladrin.
Yep.
No, 19 versus that armor hits. Class. Five points of damage. Eladrin, make a constitution saving throw. Alright, you feel the poison going through your body and you shake it off. The snakes are done. Dakar, make a death saving throw.
Oh boy.
Fail.
You are one fail on your death saving throw. Two more and your character is dead. Kellen, you see this snake bite Dakar again, lunging at him, probably catching a point near his heart, and Dakar is fallen on the ground. You still have two snakes around you with a Melisande to your side.
Okay.
You should probably go ahead, never mind.
What were you going to say?
I was going to tell Clint to take one of the two pythons off the turn order.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, this one. Let's go.
Where does the other big python go?
It's right where it is. It essentially, I haven't listed it as a zero. It was a late addition. Yeah, it was a late addition. It heard what happened to its master, and that's what caused it to go into a rampage and break the door down.
Alright, I'm gonna do an attack on one of the snakes. I guess it doesn't hit, since it didn't hit before with a 13.
But you have many allies around it. You have flank, but
That's only advantage. It still doesn't hit.
Yeah. No.
The dice are not favoring you tonight, Kellen.
How I wish I had precision attack. How I wish. But it's okay.
Alright. You miss. Anything you want to do? You want to move? You would provoke attack of opportunity? Do you want to do any kind of tactics you might have available?
I don't have any.
Also, you still have, if you choose, your lucky points.
Yeah, maybe I'll just go ahead and do that so I can get some kind of something in. So,
yeah, they recharge on a long rest, right? You have three of them.
Yeah, so I'll use one of those and reroll my attack.
Reroll. This will be once, so just roll it once and I'll count whatever the left result is. This is not on advantage.
So I'm rerolling my attack. Like I
yes.
Yeah,
yes.
So just d20.
Kellen has the lucky traits.
Yep.
From his current level 4.
Plus that's plus whatever, so.
It hits. So, you see your friend go down. And which snake are you attacking? The one that attacked your friend or the one that's attacked your other friend?
The one that attacked the friend that's dead. Or mostly
just
dead.
Just left click on it.
Yeah, that one.
You face this snake enraged. And do you want to describe your kill, or you just slice him up?
I just slice him up.
You make snake sushi.
Rest in pepperonis, cleric.
Rest in pepperonis, cleric. Maybe the party won't put you in the front line next time.
We didn't put him in the front. He put himself in the front.
This is true. And he blew a whole bunch of stuff up and himself up in the process. Eldrin. Your turn.
Flanking.
Yes. So
that's 5 feet.
Yes.
Wow.
With advantage. Ooh.
Nope.
The snake, like, ducks under your spear.
Oh,
curling, hissing.
Oh, I was going to see if we could see the health of it, but I'm trying to think.
I mean, you have a bonus action.
I know. I'm trying to think if I want to use two attacks or one attack. I don't know its HP.
You do not. You just see it is damaged.
I'll just
it's
one.
Just a little snake.
Stomp its face in.
You hit it. And you may stomp its face in whatever manner you wish.
I jump up and do like a down kick on it. Just smash it. And then
smash
after that
goes the snake.
I move to there.
And I'm gonna make a marker on this one. Essentially, that's the one that didn't get blown up the smithereens. This is also one that didn't get blown up the smithereens. Because I know you guys like scavenging for parts and crap.
Yep. I'm dipping arrows in that blood, man.
That green blood all day long. It does nothing. Bechtold.
All right, I'm going to...
Leric is down.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm gonna Thunder Wave the snake.
He finally gets a chance.
Finally get a chance to what?
Thunder Wave.
It's the Thunder Wave.
Oh, I cast Thunder Wave
last time. Yeah,
yeah, you did. Centered from where? Because you might hit Akka. Akka is currently grappled by this snake, but
no, it's not going to hit Akka.
It's target. Yeah,
it's a 15. It's 15, I think.
No,
right, but it's 15 from the front of me.
Yeah, so it's more.
Okay. All right. So yes. All right. I got you. I know where it's going. Yep. Roll Thunderwave.
That one should be set up right. Yeah.
No, because he's used it. That DC is pretty high.
Yes.
So, it takes 11 thunder damage.
And shoved back into its damn
room. And it is shoved back inside the room. Kind of just get, like, squished through the doorway.
I was going to say, would it actually fit through the doorway? If it's coiled
one
up?
Time.
It did, but it did that on its way out, meaning
but,
it had
but, like,
to.
It was coiled up with Akka. He blasted it, and it just kind of like, just kind of like a long string going back through the doorway.
Does Akka get pulled with it? If he's
Akka is freed. Akka is no longer grappled.
Yeah, that's one of the nice things about grapple. If somebody else is shoved away, I don't have to go with them.
That's pretty cool.
And it's not dead?
Perception.
Actually, I think it is right here. Oh, no, it's not dead. You can perception. Because it was...
let me perception real
here.
Quick. And
5, 10.
Yeah, hang on. Give me a second. I'm going to... Perception...
Maybe not.
Is that better. Is that 3 going to hit?
No.
And then I'm going to use my bonus action to cast Bardic Inspiration on Akka.
Appreciate it.
What
was
going to
cast it on you, Dakar, but you died before my turn.
What do you say?
What?
What do you say for your Bardic
Inspire
Inspiration?
Him.
Oh, gotcha. Some sweet shoes you got there.
About to get some new boots. Give me a second.
Make some new snakeskin boots. Alright. 1 is Bechtel, 2 is Akka. Did it roll?
No.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, it did.
1 is Bechtel. So it comes back out. It's obviously not happy. And I think it can reach from here. Yes, it has reached. Oh, actually, no. If I want to get him to constrict you, I'm going to get him right here, right in your business.
No, actually, you actually were right to begin with.
You were right.
Because he extends all the way?
Yeah. He has his 5-foot reach is everything that's in the surrounding squares around his 3x3.
Okay. All right, so here comes a constrict attack. No, 19.
Well, at disadvantage because he's hexed.
He is hexed. I'm not worried. 16 against armor class.
13.
Yep.
Ouch.
He is going to lunge at you just as he did against Akka.
I'm not worried. Akka's the damage dealer. He picked the wrong
target.
You
take 16 points of bludgeoning damage. And you are considered grappled by the snake. I will mark this. Yeah, I mean, if it had grabbed Akka, Akka would be able to like, hand his turn. But I let the dice say it for me. Ouch.
Holy
big snake hurt.
Fucking paper toy over here.
Now,
oh, I'm sorry. All the people with armor over stomping little snakes.
Hey, I went after the big guys to try and take them off. I'm just saying, okay?
Speaking of bigger snakes, there's a friend y'all forgot about.
Nobody forgot about nobody.
No, Mateo didn't forget about it. Mateo was trying to finish him off. Everybody else went after the little guys.
Someone forgot about the Malison. Who will then turn to... let me think.
I was getting the snakes away from our healer, so...
Who will turn to Eladrin, given he's on his side.
The dead one?
This guy, who is alive, will turn to Eladrin and make 2 attacks with his snake arms.
Wait, did he just move over there?
He was just
no,
showing
that's
no,
me just showing,
showing
you which
snake.
One it is.
Oh.
That one's not going to hit.
That hits.
20 versus armor class. Finally, he gets a hit. They don't do much damage. That's the whole point. They're just supposed to be tanky. That didn't work. Because he has snakes for arms, so he doesn't do much damage.
Are you going to do the
damage?
There
really are snakes for arms? Like, I was about to ask that as a joke, but that's really what he has.
His arms are snakes. Literally, they are
the most worthless
instead
arms
of arms.
Planet.
You see, like those the size of those poisonous snakes that y'all been killing, those are his arms, and he just lashes at people.
Okay, that must be fun.
So,
utensils.
He's really bad at interviews. Nobody ever shakes his hands.
Oh wait, plus this. because snakes have poison. 12 points of damage, Eldrin.
I don't... No chance to resist it?
Nope, not this one. This one doesn't course through the body. It just, like, immediately impacts you.
Hold on. No. It was at 27. I already taken it off. So 27 minus 12.
Damn it. Fine. 15. 27 minus 12.
That's why I was, like, trying to do the math.
It was like, you did it again, Clint. All right. Okay. Akka.
Cool. I am going to cast, Oh, no, actually, I'm just going to step back. Cast Eldritch Blast. Oh, wait, no, actually, I'm going to cast Scorching Ray. I forgot, I've already used my Hex. Mm-hmm. So, excuse me, not Scorching Ray, Glacial Ray. So, sadly, I only have line of sight on
Rachel
one.
Ray?
All right, so you hexed the giant snake, did you not?
I did last time, yeah, you just didn't mark it.
Yep.
That was what I was confused about. And since I only have one target, all three of them fire off at the big snake.
Yeah, this is gonna hurt.
I think he's dead, Jim.
All right, we'll find out, Jim.
I think I just came in my pants.
16. Hey, yo. 21. What the hell is that 3d6?
Hex applies every time I hit it.
Oh, wow.
That's what I was saying.
I'm looking that up.
I'm not
up.
Worried about it.
I am looking that up, because now I want to play a Warlock.
I can give you the Twitter where they explain, yes, Eldritch Hex works that way to work with multiple rays from Eldritch
Whenever
Blast.
You hit it with an attack, yeah, holy balls. Yeah, that works. That is 16, 21, 29 points of damage.
Oh, and he doesn't get to save.
No, he doesn't, because it's an attack roll. This snake just... I'll say explode, because
hang
it's...
Hang on. Hold that what? Thought.
Blow its head off.
Hang on. Bardic Inspiration is 1d6 or 1d8?
You're it's just going to use 1D8. That now? It lasts for, like, 10 minutes, I think, man. Maybe an hour.
I mean, is it dead?
It freezes.
Okay.
Through the sheer cold of your rays.
So, with that, I just, you know... thump three large chunks of ice out of its flesh, and then I look over at Bechtel and I was like, new shoes.
new ice shoes that'll melt in the desert? Nice.
As I land on my feet, I brush myself off, give Akka a fist bump.
Alright, bro bump, baby.
Okay, so hang on. 5, 10, 15, 20... does Dakar, since he's prone, count as,
difficult?
Mm-hmm.
If you don't want to step on him.
He's blocking the doorway. I'd say, this time.
Right, but he's prone.
Right, I was, that, my
How
point
big
is
he?
Horses still count as difficult terrain.
Yeah, it would still do it. Like, if I'm alive, I can move out of the way and you can still walk through it.
Oh, and technically, he's not... dead, he's just
I know.
5, 10,
and if you're being careful not to step on your friend that is dying.
Couldn't he go
thunder
in?
Wave him out of the way?
Couldn't right, he go in on top of the snake?
Yeah, well, I just step, I'm not through because he's in the doorway, so I'm just stepping there. That's 30.
Well, right, but he doesn't want to stand next to him and provoke an attack of opportunity either.
But the snakes are all dead.
No,
not the one Tim was telling you to go next to.
What's
Tim wanted you to stand here.
Why?
No, I was saying you could.
It's fine, it don't matter.
Could you put the Yuan-Ti back, by the way? That's what's throwing me off.
He's alive, right here.
Yeah, he's right next
to
me.
All these markers on him. You want me to move some of the corpses?
Oh, that's weird. No, for me, he's right here.
Really?
On my end. Yeah, hang on. Refreshing roll 20. That's what I was like, why? You know, okay. So yeah, refreshing. Let's see if that'll actually show him where he should be. Hey, there he is. Okay, cool.
Okay.
Hey, is there a way to change the color of the X's?
No.
Because I was going to say, there's a lot of stuff in Roll20 that has red tones.
Yeah.
So I was thinking if we make them a different color, like green or blue or something like that, they'll stand out. So it's obvious what's dead and what's not.
I could do something. Hold up. I'll let you know which one's alive. This one.
Can you put a red box around him?
I'm not red. This one's alive.
Could you put a box around him? Is what I'm saying.
I don't know what this one is.
We don't see anything.
Oh shit! All right. It'll be obvious when I show it to you.
That's the only one that's alive.
Yeah. That's why I'm next.
That one's alive.
Okay, that's perfect.
Just as a, like, GM note, Clint, I usually just take the bodies and I just pile them up somewhere else because it really doesn't matter where they are.
Yeah. Let's drag them all.
Well, it might if I don't want you to get through that door, but there are all kinds of bodies of snakies over here and here.
And you can just drag the python back into the other room.
Like, he's not in the way, so.
Okay. You can just drag.
He is frozen. You might have to break through him to get into that room.
You can drag the car up to the barbecue.
Yeah.
Okay, Mateo, sir.
I wonder what I'm going to do. All right, let me go here. Wrong one. There we go.
Now, you're kind of in close range, so if you shoot with the longbow, that is disadvantage.
Is it? At 10,
even if I have
15 feet.
Proficiency?
Wait, what's the question?
Is he at disadvantage if within 15 feet with the longbow?
No. There's the only time you get disadvantage is... it's if you're in melee and you took... Hang on, and you took the crossbow feat?
Yeah.
So, no disadvantage ever for ranged attacks while in melee like that.
Oh, cool.
Yep. I could take that as a warlock and even have that function. Oh, well.
Wow, it's dead because that's a crit.
Hold on.
That's a natty 20.
Well, he's got to do all those additional fun rolls.
So that's 17. I need to macro this for him.
Yep.
17, 25. No, 24.
24.
He's dead, Jim.
Yeah.
It had exactly 24 HP.
The Ranger's done this multiple times with exact hits.
Yes, he has.
That's why we're precision-based killing machines.
Do you want to describe your kill?
Kind of kneeling behind Dakar in payback. I unleash an arrow since it's still facing Eldrin, I take and just put it right at the base of its spine, so it comes out through its mouth, like kind of up to the haft of the arrow, and it just falls like face first at the feet of Eldrin.
It's like, I got you a present. All right. Well, that took some time, but. This is essentially one of the core encounters that I had planned for this dungeon. And the car's body just lies on the ground.
Are we out of combat and out of, what's it called?
Yes.
Okay, I'm giving him one of my potions.
Hang on, save those.
Yeah, I gotta save first.
He can do a save, but we also could use...
Well, no, initiative's over.
Yeah, I could just walk up and give him a potion instead of him having to use that
save. I mean, if you can save if you want to be cool. If you get a nat 20, you come back up.
My point being, I wouldn't even do that. We can just use... Somebody has medicine.
I as do, a skill. I think.
That stabilizes him.
Right, with one health.
Oh. What? No,
I have medicine.
Who does?
I think I have.
Because I do.
Double check.
I know for a fact that Kellen has medicine.
I do, yeah.
So,
either one of us.
I think the DC is just 10.
Meanwhile, while they're doing that, I walk up to the halfling and I'm like,
sorry.
How's it going?
Yeah, I'm going to go to the other side of him with Bechtel.
Where's the DC? I'm looking at the medicine skill right here. And all it says is, lets you stabilize companion or diagnose an illness.
I think it's up to DM.
No, this is set. I think it's honestly just 10.
I believe it is just 10. I'm going to...
It's probably the exact same as for a death save, but from someone
stabilize
else.
Any creature. Yeah, it's DC Wisdom 10. It has 0 hit points. It remains unconscious.
Ah.
See? Okay. A stable creature that... regains one hit point after 1d4 hours. So if you guys want to sit here a bit.
Not particularly.
That's a short rest.
Yeah, I was going to say, short rest would be just...
It depends what I roll. It's 1d4 hours.
Right. Yeah. What I was going to say, though, is potions are fleeting and limited. Bechtold has... Well, actually, I don't know. Bechtold, do you have a healing word?
Healing word? No, I don't think so.
Yeah, and I didn't take a healing spell.
Hang on. Let me double check my stuff real quick.
Hence in the meantime, the healer going in the front.
We know.
Sure. I have cure wounds.
Oh, okay, yeah. So he's got cure wounds, even better.
Well, he's stabilized, just cure him. As soon as I stabilize him, I walk off and grab a snake and throw it on the fire and start cooking.
In the meantime, I ask Mateo, hey, see that chest over there? Can you shoot it with an arrow for me?
Mateo will shoot the chest with an arrow.
You don't even have to roll. An arrow clangs off the chest, and it hisses. No, I'm just kidding.
I was like, you should have seen my face just now. I was like, wait, what?
No. Nothing happens.
Okay, cool.
Can I?
I seem to relax a little bit.
Yeah, I don't know. Can we talk to the? Is she conscious on the table?
Yes, absolutely. Who wants to approach the halfling?
That's why I moved there. I was gonna.
Yeah.
Bechtold approaches the halfling. She's like,
"What's up? How's it going?"
Oh, I thought I was a goner. They were gonna turn me into one of them.
That would be unfortunate.
I'd already heard the screams of several others. They take the corpses out and they pile them. I was the last one to be sacrificed for the evening.
Huh. Good thing we got
cool. My name is Fadia. I am the daughter of the mayor of Fasalam.
I knew that name sounded familiar.
You had never heard of Fadia.
Oh, really? So, it sounds really familiar.
Is there gonna be like a reward?
Do we need to play? Can we do a perception? Can we see if there's anything, if she's telling the truth with perception or anything? Or?
It's insight. Sure. It's insight.
While they're doing this, I searched one of the snakes, and as soon as I finish searching it, I literally throw one of the
pythons on
the fire.
Well, I'll go with Akka's insight.
She is telling the truth. She is indeed Fadia, only daughter to the mayor of Fasalam. Mr. What's his name? Because I haven't given him a name.
I take it she's chained here. Do I need to roll to pick the locks?
I was going to say, I'll just Eldritch Blast the chains.
Well, we might be able to save them, use them for something else.
Like what?
I don't know. Chaining if we find a prisoner we want to keep.
People. Oh my god.
If we find a prisoner we want to keep.
Imprison snake people.
Or if she starts misbehaving, we just put the chains back on her.
Jeez.
We should just keep her on the table and roll her
around. That turned kinky.
Yeah.
You've been a bad girl getting these chains.
oh my god. Real quick, before we get too much, did we.
We need to cure wounds to Car.
That's what I was going to say. Bechtold, you use cure wounds, right?
Yeah, is he stable?
It doesn't matter.
I stabilize them. He's stable.
When you heal someone HP, they immediately come up off the ground.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Bing!
Poof.
Alright, cast me a cure wounds. Let's see how much he heals.
I just point down at him and I go, get the fuck up. Lazy.
Well, you do have to touch him, so, you know.
Yeah,
cast me a cure wounds. I gotta see how much he heals.
I gotta find it. That's a cantrip, right? First level?
First level, not cantrip.
Way to lay on the ground for the whole fight.
Dekar, you healed 9 HP. You're standing on your feet. You see all the snakes that you had previously encountered lying dead. You see Eladrin roasting one on the
I'm
fire.
I'm roasting one
the
of the
corner.
Pythons. It's more food.
And then you look behind you. You see this giant ass snake. Like completely frozen, like a snake sculpture. And like, when did that icicle get there?
Can I do something?
Should anyone tell him he was sound asleep?
Can I do something real quick?
Maybe.
I'm gonna ask everybody to move off to the side of the doorway real quick.
Okay.
I'm gonna like crawl over to the side.
I'm dragging this fucker up and putting it next to the fire to defrost it so we can take some skin.
make a strength check. This thing is huge.
I'm not helping.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I'll watch. Oh, no, I take that back. I will cast Mage Hand and give it a...
Make a strength check.
I'm looking for it. I forgot where it is.
Skills, bottom, unskilled strength check.
That's not enough. This thing is huge. The Mage Hand tries to help you, but it's just not good at dragging giant things.
Well, Eldrin, I'll come over and try Eldrin, and drag just it.
Just stop. All right, Kellen. Kellen, roll a straight check. I'll take your initial check, Eladrin.
Second.
Essentially, you guys need to meet a certain total to drag this
there
in.
There we go.
That will meet it. Kelladrin and Eladrin's combined efforts drag the frozen snake, bits of ice kind of breaking off of it. They drag it over and start defrosting it around the fire.
Daddy needs a new sleep bag.
Bechtold, would you like to go for that chest that he shoot an arrow at?
Yeah.
Is it locked? Right.
The chest is locked.
I'm gonna thunder wave it.
No!
Hold on. Bechtold, I got this. Just watch out. I got this.
He's after Mateus sees you fumbling with it, getting frustrated.
I've seen Bechtold, thunder this, shock that.
I haven't acid spit yet, though. I was thinking about it with that snake.
Where is it? There it is.
So, looking around the room, what's down this way? Now that,
Hold on. Let's just, you want to clean up the room first before we, because if we get into another fight, we're all
No, the point being, this is a dead end, and those look like cell bars.
Yeah,
but
they are.
I can't quite tell. Yeah.
They are, because there's one in the corner over here.
You see one corpse.
Yes.
I'm just going to walk all the way down.
Was the lockpick successful, by the way?
Yes, it was successful. And the final two are empty.
Cool. All right, so while Mateo is working with the lockpick and the chest, I'm going to suggest...
It was successful. Inside, you see...
a note.
Probably not. I think he's done writing notes.
You don't know that.
He trailed off.
Inside is a note that says, lol, you thought it was a mimic.
What you can easily identify as two more potions of healing. But on top is a bag.
A bag, you say?
Hang on. Let me roll Arcana. And even then... Yeah, I still wouldn't put anything in there that you care about. Give me a little bit to actually look this thing over.
Yeah.
Do we have to be trained in Arcana to look at it?
No. Do you choose...
This?
You don't have to put anything in it, but do you choose to pick the bag up?
No, hold on. I got an idea. I'm going to put snake pieces in it.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Let's throw some snake in it.
All right.
You drop feel like bits you should have put a fang on it.
You drop bits of snake into the bag, and you open it, and you don't see the snake bits inside.
Is it a bag of holding? Is our bag of holding now going to smell like rancid snake for the rest of forever?
Here's the thing. There are bags of holding, and then there are bags of devouring.
This is true.
Oh, man. I want that bag. Nobody else wants it. I need it in my life.
After seeing that, can I make another Arcana check?
Yeah. Anyone want to help?
I'll help.
Yeah, I don't really know if I can do anything for
it. What if we're not trained in it? Can we still do it?
Yeah, sure. You might need some help.
Damn!
Oh, and actually, Bechtold might actually be...
Yeah, Bechtold has been adventuring.
And he, does know his magic.
And he rolled a 20. Bechtold and Akka determined this is indeed a bag of holding. Bag of holding has an interior space considerably larger than its outside dimensions, roughly 2 feet in diameter at the mouth and 4 feet deep. The bag can hold up to 500 pounds, not exceeding a volume of 64 cubic feet. All these details I never really care about. Here's the important part. You have to, declare what you're reaching in for to draw it out of the bag, because it's in an extra-dimensional space. If it doesn't
exist,
it doesn't exist.
Can we take the dead snake bits out of the bag, please?
Can I climb inside of it?
So, like, you you can.
If can I get can back get, out if I
if
do?
If you can get out, you might have to roll some checks to get out. Maybe or some climbing
could,
checks.
Or we could request him. And you would summon out of the bag.
Or they might be, like, open the they bag. Might be jackasses and leave you in there.
No.
They're just going to be like, they're only going to let me out when they need inspiration.
No, because you'd only last about 10 minutes in there.
There's no air.
I would thunder wave everything in the bag.
just turn everything into slurry.
And picking up the bag, you see something shiny on the bottom.
Did I pick up the bag or they picked up the bag?
Mateo's the one standing by the chest. Mateo, you see...
I will hand the bag to Bechtold.
Okay.
Well, he's saying there's something
essentially,
else in the chest.
Essentially, the bag is now just going to be what y'all hold all y'all's stuff in. It's what allows me to not care much about weight.
Is there a way for
so
us to see
if there will be, like, one person who's carrying all the stuff, which won't really matter unless that one person gets isolated or falls to the ground. So bear that in mind. There will be one person to be all stuff carrier. Also, by the end of this dungeon, even though you all have, like, separate gold amounts, there'll probably need to be at least... one treasurer who's like,
do you really want to vote a person who's up front, or would you rather put one of us that's in back?
Yeah, that's why, like, Bechtold.
That's y'all's decision.
I'm usually in the back. I mean, I'd say either Bechtold, Ocker, or myself.
Y'all can decide this during, like, well, determine who has the bag now, but treasurer, that's downtime. Anyway, Mateo, in the bottom of the chest, you see an ornate bronze key.
Okay, I'm going to take the key then.
Okay.
And there's nothing else in there? Do I need a perception for it, or...?
No. There's nothing else in the chest. The bag, the key...
You know what? While you guys are doing this, I'm going to slap myself in the face and cure wounds.
Actually, that's what I was trying to say earlier. Do we want to go ahead... Whoa, hang on before you cast that.
Wow.
And do a short rest, so that way use... Hit die instead of spell slots.
Why does it keep doing
that? He's got his whole thing in there. I want to go look.
Bechtold, I was thinking the same thing.
You guys are no. I'm holding the bag still right now. I am not. No, there's no bag. Snakes in the bag. By the way, since the chest is empty,
in a motherfucking bag.
Can I recover arrows or no?
Can recover.
There might be live snakes in the bag. You don't know. There might be other treasure in the bag. You don't know. You have to declare something or think about it to pull it out of the bag. Or
I put my hand in the bag and I say, ale.
Actually, we can
don't
just
find
turn
any
it,
ale.
We can just turn it inside out. And dump
you can turn it inside out, and all the stuff within the bag then gets dumped out.
Oh, okay.
Why don't we make sure it's safe and dump it out into
I
a
turn
cell?
Turn it inside out. In the cell.
Yeah.
Right there.
Yep. We're doing this.
Alrighty.
I'm ready to make sure... He probably has the gate open. I'm ready to slam that damn gate.
seeing...
Wait a minute. There's no air in there, right? So anything that
animals
would be alive...
Animals wouldn't survive, no.
Yeah. Maybe there's an elder god in there.
Oh, hell yeah.
All right. You dip out the contents of the bag, and inside you find...
A bunch of snake falls out.
More halflings.
No. Some gems dump out.
Oh.
How much more? I'll add it to our existing total.
I'm trying to count how many of y'all are again. Six.
Who is that that's saying they'll add it to the existing total?
Our merchant.
Akka, the treasurer.
Yeah,
I'm going to vote for Akka to be the treasurer then. Just make him. He's already.
Yeah, he already is. The bag to Akka. He's a merchant, anyways.
Yeah.
Okay, I will add bag of holding.
Six gems dump out. Shiny gems, little transparent, pale, yellow brown citrines. Each of them going for 50 gold apiece.
I have a question. Is the snake
and
defrosted?
Six, so one for each of you, 50 gold apiece. Snake is definitely defrosted by now.
Okay, can I see the bag of holding?
No.
I hold it up and I say,
wait, no,
see?
It's a giant ass snake. It's not defrosted by now. If you want the snake to be defrosted, you'll have to at least take a short rest.
Oh man, I want to take it back to town and do a magic trick and pull that shit out.
I hand Akka the bag.
Thank you.
You guys don't want to show the town what we killed? Just be like, look, what I found is keep pulling a snake out like a magic trick?
No, not at all.
And then we need to, can we search the bodies? Can we search the bodies of at least the two bigger guys and then check if there's anything else?
One of those bodies of the snake, physically.
No, do you want to?
No, the snake people, the...
Yeah.
The Yuan-Ti have nothing on them.
I'm going to... Is this cell locked?
Because this guy didn't even have any weapons. All he had were snake arms. the cells, yeah, the cells are locked.
Mateo.
Okay. Yeah.
How does he hold himself to pee?
Oh.
He doesn't. It's a snake. It aims itself.
Oh, my God.
Alright, so this cell with the body in it.
Did I unlock it?
Did he die on us?
No, I'm here. Yeah, you got it. These were crude locks. The snakes just needed them to hold these adventurers after they had stripped all their stuff. You can examine
the corpse. Can I search the room and the person with perception before I walk in?
Why? It's a cell. Who booby traps a cell?
It might be a zombie.
Yeah, I'm going to poke it with my spear.
You find no traps. You poke the corpse with your spear. The blunt It does not react.
Okay. I'm going to search it.
And search the corpse.
You know what? I'm going to drag it out to here and be like, what could I find?
Why would they leave anything on a prisoner, though?
So, they're stink people. The corpse is female, and then this strikes you, because now this corpse is a female, the halfling is a female, and Vadia speaks up and says, yeah, it seems to be mostly women that they are capturing. They seem to be using some kind of dark magic to impregnate the women, to create more of their own kind. And you get the sense this was some kind of breeding chamber.
Creepy.
Oh, wow. Yeah, creepy. So there's nothing else in the cell?
By the way, she's still chained to the table?
No, we said we did those.
You have saved her. I'm just going to do this and...
Put her in the bag of holding? All right.
Make her stand up like that. Yay.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
I'll have a separate token for her now. So that's her token right now.
Okay. So now that everybody's had their fun, we lock that door or barricade it up with whatever's nearby.
Well, hold on. Before we do that, can I go to here and do a perception to see if there's any traps in this room?
Yes, you may.
While he's doing that, how much does this chest weigh?
Put it in the bag of holding.
Yeah, that's what I want to do.
It's like putting a bag in a bag.
I know, that's amazing.
Because if we make a nice house later, we have a chest on the ready.
Not only that, if we make camp, pull a chest out and put the stuff in it. Pull the chest out, put the bag of holding in the chest, and lock the chest.
Wait, can you turn the bag of holding inside out?
We already did.
But all it does is dump everything out.
Yeah.
So are we now inside the bag of holding?
No.
Oh, I see what
there is a thing, though. A bag of holding cannot exist in another extra-dimensional space. If it does, both of them collapse on each other. Anything inside the bag is lost. And I think anyone that was holding the bag gets teleported to a random plane.
Yeah.
So don't do that.
How much does that chest weigh?
Probably 10 to 20 pounds.
Okay, I'm going to pick it up and carry it over and look at them and be like, can I put this in the bag for later use?
Arka just kind of stares at you and face palms.
Oh, he's over here.
Can we like, tunnel through the wall by pressing the bag against it?
It's not a bag of devouring, but
no.
That would be amazing.
No,
Did I notice anything here with my roll?
The room's not trapped.
Okay. So I'm going to go in and then do a perception in the room to try and figure out if there's anything worth value.
Yeah. In this room, within one of the crates, you find... a hand crossbow with some bolts.
God.
Okay. I know.
Did I find two of them?
You only find one.
Too much. Asking too much.
But some of these bolts seem a little more well crafted than the others.
Okay, so that was it? There's nothing else in there?
Regular supplies and stuff. Useless for y'all.
Are any of the supplies the supplies we came looking for?
I'm going to go back to Akka and Bechtold and ask them
to...
They're
not the supplies you're looking for.
Identify anything special about these bolts.
I totally just waved my hand over the screen as I did that.
These are not the bolts you're looking for. Can I ask Akka and Bechtold to inspect the bolts and see if there's anything, you know...
I look over them and I'm like, yeah, they're crossbow bolts.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
And they're crossbow bolts.
I like this idea of Mateo walking around. What do you guys think? Do these look
well, we're all grouped up pretty much. He just pulls it out and we're all like, scratching our chins.
Five of these bolts are ammunition plus one.
Ooh.
So crossbow bolts plus one.
Yep.
All right, cool. Now that everybody's had their time to run around, let's all take a little break and get some health back.
Let's secure the room first.
No, go back to our other room.
We don't want to stay in this
dungeon
place.
Yeah.
Well, do we perception this room to see if there is anything else to check?
You perception this room a fair bit. There's nothing else within here.
Okay. So
can
you guys
just go around and slap everyone in the face with cure wounds?
Don't save your spell slots because you have only so many of those per day. We, however, have plenty of hit dice to use to have everybody heal out.
But I just want to slap you guys.
Yeah, save that for, you know, when you can slap us to wake us up or something.
All right, so we're all going to move back to our special room of...
I'm taking my cooked snake with us.
I rolled a 17. Do I perceive anything in that storeroom?
No.
You perceive boxes.
Oh, that's the one I just checked, Bechtold.
Oh, it was?
That's where I got my hand crossbow. Oh, I need to write that down, don't I? I put it in my inventory.
Yeah.
Yes, you do.
Were there any torture tools in this room?
No, because they didn't need them. They used their own natural implements.
Can I take two snake arms?
Like their snake arms, and they use the snakes around them, which are like part of attuning the ritual. This is definitely... This is not natural for women to give birth to snakes. They have to be using some...
Wait, what? Since when?
some dark forbidden magic to impregnate these women.
Fallen, what's the site that you got the weapons from?
What?
Or where'd you get the weapon information from so I can put it in my...
Oh, hold on. Can one of you link the Dropbox in Skype? All the corpses, I'm going to drag to the same spot, and I want to do a nature check and see if I can figure out if... any of them have poison or stuff still left on them.
And that's my roll for my short rest, by the way.
Oh, wow.
The 1d6 is his Song of Rest usage.
All right. Oh, yeah, okay. So before you guys left, as you were resting... Where are you resting? Are you resting?
Resting over in our nice little small... All right,
those that are in the room are taking a... short rest, and the bard plays a little tune.
Well, hold on. Is Dakar going to rest or Eldrin or no?
Yeah,
I'm going to, but I wanted to check these for poison.
All right, you guys are just chilled for a bit. You will all rest when you all get there, because he's like, I will play a tune to help everyone rest when we're all here. Also, she joins you. So... she wants to get away out of that room as quickly as possible.
That's for acquiring poison.
You acquire, so the constrictor snakes aren't necessarily poisonous.
No,
on the ones that weren't blown to smithereens, which there are just two of them, you get two poison glands.
Okay, cool.
Two giant snake glands.
I'm done in there. When Dakar and I leave, I'm closing the door and pushing a statue in front of it for now.
Okay.
No, why?
Also, Akka, you're familiar is... its token, rather, is just here.
Well, I mean, it's out of, you know.
Yeah, I know.
I'm keeping track of it.
Yeah. All right, those who want to rest should return to the group, expend any hit dice that you choose, and then you get to add, so just that one, an additional one, because he rolled.
No, it's an additional 1d6 per hit dice used.
Right, and it's not his roll. Everybody rolls an additional 1d6.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay, interesting. Cool.
Do all we right. have, so where do
spend
I get
spend your dice, and then you can roll a 1d6 and add the result to your heal.
Hold on, let's see how much HP I'm missing. Oh, none. Okay.
Critmas, it has been a goal of ours to improve the production every single time, but unfortunately some people are just dealing with things in life right now and are
webcams
moving across
the
country, and some people just don't have access to webcams. We'll try at some point to get it, but at least not now.
And Dakar, you could roll another hit die if you wanted to do another D8 and another D6. Just make sure you subtract them.
No, I'll just keep. I'll
That's
just
what
keep
I just did. I just rolled two and got back to one blow max.
Oh, hey, look! And all my spells are back.
Yeah, all my what's it called back? My key.
And Dakar's got his channel divinity back.
Oh baby, I'm not going in first.
Yeah, you may not want to.
What armor are you wearing, by the way? Are you not wearing, like, heavy?
Scale.
Oh, okay.
DM, the hand crossbow is just a regular hand crossbow, or there's nothing special about it?
There's nothing special about it. Only the ammo is enchanted.
Okay. And it was just five of the ammo.
Five of the ammo. I mean, and there are regular bolts, but five of them were enchanted.
Great.
Also, remember, you guys did acquire that oil of slipperiness. That, and I'll try and get some handouts of all these sent out to people who own items. I'll check your inventories after tonight's venture.
Okay, so I won't worry about putting the hand crossbow in now, then.
I'm like, please put the hand crossbow in your inventory. The enchanted items, the magic items, I will get handouts ready for.
The hand crossbow, I can give you that info real quick.
Can you? Because, yeah, I just wanted to put it in my inventory so that way I had,
All right, so everyone has spent hit dice. These are marked off on your sheet.
Yes.
Yep.
Yeah, it doesn't automatically mark it off, which confuses me, so.
Yeah. I think I might be able to, make a tool or something later. So you guys can continue exploring now. Fadia is like, I don't know much more about the layout of this place. They just brought us in and took us straight to the chamber, to the cells.
Do we want to take her outside or leave her in here?
I mean, we should take her back to the town.
Well,
I say leave her in this room for now.
I say that's a terrible idea.
Well, I don't want to take her through a damn dungeon.
Well,
we're not taking her through,
you guys,
we're taking her out.
As you guys decide that, we can take a 5-minute break here. 5-10 minute. People could get drinks or go to the restroom, whatever it may be. And then in our downtime, you're free to discuss what you want to do with Fadia. Now, whatever you decide, she may or may not be willing to comply.
Okay.
Oh, wow. Could you have made that sound a little bit creepier at all?
I could. I can make it sound much creepier if you would like.
Right. I mean, we are in a room with beds.
Oy vey. All right. 5-minute break.
5-minute break. We'll be back. Let me get some.
So, what's the crit damage on that? I'm trying to figure that out.
6. It's the max on the die.
Okay. And,
Let's turn it down.
When I put the damage on it for the plus one ammo, should it just be 1d6 plus one?
Correct.
Okay.
It's also plus one on your attack roll. You need that.
I don't believe it's on the attack roll for ammunition.
Yes, it is. I'm looking at it right now.
Really? Wow.
All right, we're back. Sorry, we were conversing. Here's the music.
Hi, folks.
All right. So,
one of our people has to leave early.
One member of the group has to work tomorrow.
No, in a minute.
It doesn't matter. Also, the group typically does 3 hours. We started at 7 EST. It's closing in on our end time. We hate to leave everyone hanging, but I think the group has decided to take Fadia back home and then possibly collect a reward. Who knows?
Should we take the bodies of the loved ones back as well for their families?
We should, just so that if her father doesn't give us a reward, we could be like, hey, this is what could have happened.
And we dump the bag in a chest and a bunch of dead bodies fall out.
Yeah, no. But I do agree. Brother Akka will agree that we should take the bodies back. So we can take those. I'm going to strip some of the sheets off the like bedrolls and stuff like that and kind of not quite mummify them, but, you know, wrap them up.
And we can put them
in the bag of holding.
No, we could put them on the camel. We're not putting them in the bag of holding. I'm not having a bag of holding.
No.
Do we want to take the chest in this room, too?
It's an empty chest.
Yeah.
Are you carrying the chest? Because Benmeni is not carrying the chest.
The bag of holding.
I did bring my cart.
The bag of holding.
All right. You guys leaving?
It's a real question. So the bag of holding, there's no air in it.
No.
And there's no real temperature fluctuation, right? Like, it's basically a vacuum.
Bodies would probably last longer.
And it's I was going to say, so the bodies won't start to decay in the desert sun.
No, it's about a 5-6 hour journey back to Fossilam.
We should probably put them in the bag of holding.
Yeah, I agree. That's fine.
All right.
So we decided we're taking the corpses in case.
Still wrap them first. We're still going to wrap them.
Yeah.
Well, I'm doing that just out of, you know, respect. So.
Yeah. We're going to wrap them up in bed sheets.
Necessity.
Okay, right. So fast forwarding. We wrap the bodies up.
I'm getting everyone's tokens so I can carry one across.
Don't forget the chick. Yeah. There you go.
I'm not. You're in the darkness, but I can see you.
We're taking the dead bodies of some people, or are they just built into the map?
No, they're not built in, but we don't need the tokens.
Just note that you have corpses in your bag.
Of who, though? That's what we have to...
We have
the three adventures. And the one dead person that was found in the cell. That's it.
Alright, you go back, you grab them. Just know that you have them.
Okay.
Let me find some... Tam music.
Ooh, what was that? There we go.
Start the song, I think.
Yeah.
Alright. Everyone goes back to Fossilam. And all the old tokens are there. I'll get rid of them in a sec.
Also, when we finish up this stream, we need to talk about fixing up these tokens and their health bars.
What do you mean?
I'll explain later. Don't worry about it. It's a small thing.
Okay.
I just noticed now.
All right, everyone is back in Fossilam. You get through. You have to do some sweet talking to the guards, but they've seen you guys by now. They've seen you guys advancing when you saved the caravan.
One sec. Are you gonna stop the map?
Oh, you guys can't see. My bad. I carried the tokens. I didn't carry you.
I was gonna say, hold that thought. There we go. All
right, back in Fossilam. You inquire around for the house of the.
But wouldn't she know the house?
The mayor. Yeah. She's like, it's this way. Hurry.
There you go.
It's up here. It's off the map. I don't have a spot for it.
Okay.
I have it on my napkin map. I have it on my napkin map.
Don't worry about it. Just go on.
It's okay.
All right, and you are greeted by Duke Fadil. Not Duke, essentially just mayor. I'm trying to think of an Arabic word for mayor. You're greeted
Elder?
No, it's not, this is not a caliph. Caliph are in the cities.
You just might be a well-to-do merchant.
By Fadil. says, first, he sees his daughter run up to the door. It's like, Fadia! Oh, and he just grabs her in a warm embrace. Oh, my dearest Fadia, I thought I had lost you forever. She looks straight into his eyes and says, I am okay, father. I am well. I have fate to thank for, and fate that brought these adventurers to my aid. You all step forward. He says, oh, praise be to Hakia. Thank you all ever so much for recovering my daughter. She was kidnapped just a day ago. And you guys, from that description, figure out it must have been the day that you left Fossilam going back to the temple. When you went to the caravan path and then found your way to the temple for the first time. She was kidnapped in that evening.
Well, good timing.
That's why she was nice. Next. Because there was no waiting line. He says, please, please, what are your names? I am Fadil, Grand Mayor of our port city of Fossilam.
So, I will, walk forward and, formally introduce, myself as Akamanos Ruinloth, with Eladrin Dakar, Kellen, Mateo Beerman, and Bechtel Koenig.
You can take the beer man off my name. I wasn't sure to do that.
Bechtel beer man.
No, Bechtel Koenig.
I know. I thought about it. It was funny.
Introduce ourselves formally, and then mention that I was sent here by consult my notes.
I don't think we ever even named your guy.
I was gonna say. I don't think he's got a name.
No.
No, I'm Bechtold. Bechtold, what were we searching for again?
You were sent by Akamanos. You were sent to Ajayib by a grand vizier of Ajayib, and you give him his name. He recognizes the name definitely. And you say you were looking for the cause of the disturbances of the town, which you guys explain to him of. The Yuan-Ti, these snake people that have been kidnapping females, seemingly from this town and from any nearby caravans, to... Do you want to give them the dirty details, or...?
No, just let them know that there are, until we've cleared the whole place, that there are Yuan-Ti snatching villagers and travelers up, and so that everyone should remain, should not travel until we have a chance to go back. Because at this point, because it's 5 or 6 hours back to Fossilam, about what time is it? It's evening-ish, I would imagine, at this point.
Yeah, it's definitely evening.
Okay, so, nobody should leave, and...
The sun hasn't set yet, but it's around 5, 6 p.m. No.
The town should probably be on high alert.
Well, they don't need to be on high alert, but yeah, nobody should leave. Everybody should, no merchant caravans should leave tonight and try and travel during the night or anything like that. In the morning, we will be leaving to return to that temple and, purify it with righteous fire and give Dakar a thumbs up. and then it should be safe to travel back to Ajayib and use the roadways again.
Says wonderful, wonderful. Thank you, brave, mighty adventurers, for taking on this task and for assisting our town. Do you need any lodging for the evening? I could get you the best we have in Fossilam.
I could go for an ale.
As I say, we have rooms here, and we can surely probably find rooms for Bechtold and Mateo and drink. But surely there's some kind of recompense for, saving your only daughter. And I can roll diplomacy if you want. Or persuasion, excuse me.
He steps away. No, he's beside himself. He steps away inside to his estate for a bit. She follows him. She says, no, she'll stay with you guys and, like, continue thanking you, just offering her company. He comes back, like, 5 minutes later with a giant sack of gold.
Oh, yeah.
He says, it's worth every penny. It's worth every copper.
Oh, what?
Copper penny.
It's worth every copper.
What about gold?
But shush, hang on. I will take.
Worth every copper. Just means, you know, it's like
every cent.
I will priceless. Take the. I will take the bag and not look into it and just, you know, drop it into the bag of holding and, you know, kind of wave over it is. You know, we'll deal with that later.
All right.
You know, thank him profusely.
You open.
I'm not doing that out here on the street. Are you kidding me?
Okay. All right. Fine. You guys go back to the tavern.
Thank you. And I will ask Amira.
Yeah. Yeah. It's Amira. Amira.
I can't ever get the two of them. Yeah. So ask Amira. You can't even keep track.
It's Amina.
Amina.
It's Amina. Amira is the one who owns the apothecary.
Oh, okay. I know
it's
this.
It's Amina.
So, yeah, go...
See, there's a reason for this. Those have actual meanings in Arabic if you go look them up later.
So, speak with Amina and mention that we need rooms for two of our new friends, Bechtold and Mateo. The one of them can probably take Silens.
Yeah, Silens.
That one guy, take his room. So we only need one new room. And then, a private room for dinner if that can be managed.
Arranged.
She says, absolutely. Word's already spread around town that you saved Fadia. Essentially, people saw you walking in with her. Everyone knew that. I mean, if it had been a commoner, some people may not have noticed, but he put out essentially a red alert the day that he noticed his daughter was kidnapped. So the entire town, anyone that was in the market, saw you guys coming in with her. And may have thought either you were bringing her for ransom had you not also saved the caravan the day previously. So she will prepare you the finest rooms. Each person can have their own room. You settle down at the dinner table for a fabulous feast prepared by the entire staff of the tavern.
That's a little unnecessary, but thank you. We appreciate that. And so this is a private room?
Yeah.
Okay, now I pull out the bag.
It is 1,000 gold pieces.
All right, adding that to our total.
Yes.
All right.
Daddy's buying a camel.
Oh, right, and Bimini's here. I'm gonna.
Bimini's with you. Okay, you mentioned it. You would see him as you walked out. Let me go grab Bimini's token.
Wait a second. Don't lose my camel.
It's like, my camel, no.
You should put the spider on the camel.
I could roll a percentile die to see if anything happened to Bimini, but nah.
We had pretty much cleared the area anyways.
Yeah, I don't like stuff that isn't fun. Alright.
So, anyways.
You sit on Bimini. He's on the wrong layer. Go to the back.
It's alright. He's chill. He doesn't need to be inside or anything.
You should put your spider on it.
So with that gold and so I'm going to eat with them and then I'm probably going to head out to the market to see about selling the gems and the small gems and then those large citrines.
Should I try jewel crafting?
Yeah, I was going to say actually no, I'm going to here you go ahead and take the citrines cuz those are larger.
Okay.
And then the little handful of gems I'll just go get those with gold.
Yeah, for the purpose of simplicity, I say would you guys find anything worth the gold value, art objects, gems, if I give it a stated gold value, that's what it's worth. You don't have to barter to try and get more out of it. The only time you'll be bartering is for specific items.
I meant if I make jewelry out of it, would it sell for more?
He's talking about
potentially, it depends how successful you are.
Because it's the six pearls and six citrines. So.
Yeah.
We might be making it a bit too complicated with this.
I mean,
well, it's the main thing is, I don't think he's trying to get money out of it. I think as a monk and a jewel crafter, this is his thing.
It's my way to relax. Also, it's
All right. So you can attempt to do that. Everyone heals. That'll be like a jewel crafty check. That'll be intelligence, trained, proficient. Oh, you made one. So yeah, you're like taking these jewels in their raw form, and you're just trying to string them together, or?
Well, I don't think they're raw, are they? I mean, I imagine they're actually cut citrines.
Yeah. The citrines are cut, and the pearls are just pearls. They don't have to be anything. Yeah. So.
I would just.
So you're stringing them into a necklace or something.
The pearls will make a necklace. The citrines will make like amulets.
There are only six pearls. How are you gonna make it? That's a lot of whatever string between those pearls.
Yeah, put them together.
Pearl and citrines also?
Make a single item out of it.
Okay.
And alternate them.
Okay.
Pearl could do like a pearl bracelet.
Oh, hang on. I even have an image for this crap. Hang on.
Oh god. It's not a picture of a pearl necklace, is it?
No, it's a pearl and citrine necklace.
He's just gonna type it on Google and bring it up. Put it into the actual Roll20 chat.
While Kamos is going to the market, can I accompany him and see if there's any, like, you know, specialty hand crossbows or weapons?
There's a guy I know. We'll go there next.
Okay.
Okay, that image didn't want to load, so he's a different one.
Oh,
by the way, I found a great image earlier that you guys will appreciate.
Oh shit! So like the citrines are under it.
Yep.
Neat.
Obviously, we don't have that many pearls and that many citrines. Yeah. But
I thought you just like idea. I thought you could just like alternate them.
Yeah, there was actually the one I found was actually it was very just a couple citrines and a couple pearls, but it didn't.
Hey, that's what you have.
So, anyways, right. So
Mateo, Akka, you want to take him to the weapon store?
As soon as we figure out what's going on with the necklace. One thing at a time.
I mean, it's a shiny necklace. I don't know what I want to do with it yet. I'll decide before the next
year. That's fine. Okay, yeah, so Mateo and I head over to the weaponsmith shop.
Oh, I'm going too.
That's right.
I'm just dragging you to the napkin mech. Real quick so you can see it is. You guys are essentially in the market side by the tavern. So you just walk over to the weapon shop, Hamza's Armaments.
Camel stays with camel's hump. Chill out.
That's funny.
So, you know, walk in and meet Hamza.
Welcome, friend!
Just give him a kind of casual nod and kind of sidle up and new friend here. You didn't meet the last time we came through, but he's looking for hand crossbows.
Yes.
Ah. Easy.
Good.
Hand crossbow will be 75 gold pieces.
Okay. Now, if we were to, we need, we need more than that. We're not going to waste your time with just one small purchase. Armor, we need medium armor. What kind of armor do you carry that's, you know, a little bit more than just leather and hide?
Well, it's about the best you can get out in the desert without succumbing to the intense heat. Is Lamellar. Lamellar, for the purposes of our campaign, is scale mail.
Oh, you don't just have a large breastplate?
We don't get those kind of supplies down here, friend.
Fine. Then, so
studded leather is your other choice.
No. Medium. We're looking
at medium. Yeah.
Yep. And then a shield, too, I believe, Bechtold?
You can have mine. I have two.
Kellen
does
have
the
shield.
So that was just a regular hand crossbow you had? Nothing special about it?
Correct. Correct. Magic nope. items are going to be fairly rare to come by.
Except magic items are going to be rare, and they're going to be costly. All right, so 75 gold pieces for the crossbow.
Okay.
Would you like the lava lard? 50 gold.
Oh, we're buying both. Surely you're not going to charge us full price for both. I mean, and we're going to be back. I mean,
we did just save the town's daughter.
Well, the mayor's daughter.
The town's daughter?
The mayor's daughter.
That's what I meant. The mayor's daughter.
Everybody,
the mayor
you did friends, but I have a business I must run.
And so do we. We're here to protect and help people get their wares back.
Makeupers? Akka is the one in the room. Yeah. Akka, or only one of you. Make a persuasion check. Akka or Bechtold, yeah. your choice.
Waiting on you, bro. It's a 21.
Hey.
This is what I do. I have a silver tongue devil.
I was like, I'm
yeah,
going
to let right, Akka so, this. So you want the Lamalar and you want the crossbow. 125.
And some bolts.
Do you have anything besides just regular bolts? Because I picked up, what, like
no,
20 or
no,
so?
No, he does not. Yes, and essentially, I'm not...
Silver
I don't
bolts?
Count. Ammunition's another one of those things where I really don't care.
Do we need silver bolts or no?
Type. Bolts either.
No, all he has is regular bolts for basic hunting and self-defense. Because nearly anyone can use a hand crossbow. It's kind of easy.
Well, a light crossbow, probably.
Yeah.
Alright.
So, it was 125. I will... 100 gold for you, friend. For both items.
Fair enough. And then, you know, the bolts you said, right? Bolts are included with that?
Yes. It comes with a package, starter package of 20 bolts.
Alright, terrific. So 100 gold it is. Thank you. Hamza.
Okay, so I'm putting that in my inventory right now.
Yep.
Clint, do you remember how much the that ring I was looking at last time, the plus one ring cost?
Plus one ring of protection, 500 gold minimum.
I'm going to give the necklace I made to Akka and see if he can trade it for it.
That's a fair trade.
Interesting.
What?
Okay.
What are we trading for?
Well, hang on. How much were the pearls worth? Because I didn't have those written.
Yeah.
The pearls are 50. The citrines are 50.
No, the citrines are 75. Oh, wait, no, 50. Yeah, right.
Yeah.
So it's about 600 for the necklace
about
right there.
600.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
well,
I was
we could
say.
Try and get something else with it, too.
Well, I 500 minimum.
I was going to say, actually, what I'm going to do, because I hadn't thought about that, is instead of just paying the 100 gold, I will offer the necklace, the very beautiful necklace, for the lamellar armor, the hand crossbow and bolts, and the ring of protection.
He does not have the ring.
No, Rashad has the ring. That's the issue.
Oh, bother.
That's what I'm saying. We can see what else. I'll go with you, and we can see what else is in there that we want.
Well, okay. Yeah, we'll pay him 100 gold or see if we can get like that, and, you know, whatever.
All right, so 100 gold deducted from the party fund.
Then you and I go into Rashad's. Or I meet you in Rashad's.
Yep.
Well, I'm going to keep walking with Akka just because he's got all the gold and everything on him as protection. He's not walking around without that.
Because I need protection? Did you see what happened the last time a guy hit me? Actually, no, I take that back. That's only once a day. Please come with me.
You realize who you're talking to, right? The damn, yeah.
All right, so you go into Rashad's.
Bechtold, are you joining us at the magic shop?
Yeah.
Okay.
I would think everybody should, in case there's something anybody else needs.
That's true.
Does everyone want to go in the magic shop?
Yeah, we're going to pile in and, you know, fill up the tiny little room.
All right. You go
it's
in.
It's Rashad's. It's where I am.
Those who are already familiar with the place point out Bright Eyes in the corner.
I walk up and bow again.
The pseudo dragon, who is Rashad's eyes and ears.
Arcana check to recognize that he's a familiar.
Yes, he is Rashad's familiar.
Just making sure. And then, you know, I give a nod to. Bright Eyes, and then just kind of lean on the counter, kind of looking, waiting for Rashad to show up.
All right. He comes around the corner, says, "Oh, travelers, welcome back. I had heard the news. Dangerous creatures lurk down below. At least you found Fadia."
and we plan to return and find much more. We're looking to see if you have any equipment that might help us while we're out there. And, you know, we do have some things that we found that we brought to trade.
We could also spread the word of your shop for you having helped us.
I'm not doing that. that totally helps us.
All right, so I'm looking through some stuff. He looks at you and says, "It's only been a day or two since you were last in my establishments. My next shipment has not come in yet, but I do still have." And he pulls out from his cloak that same box that he showed last time. This. It opens the box and a shining, glimmering ring is within it. Again, he explains, "This ring will make you slightly more sturdier in combat."
That's nice and all. And we are potentially interested in that, but not just that. Do you happen to have a drift globe?
I do not, friend. I've heard of these items, but alas, my stock is small. I carry only, like, the necessities.
Can he just list off what he has to us then, since he doesn't have much?
He has that ring.
I was gonna say, if he doesn't have a drift globe, he's obviously really small time. I'm gonna give him a look, and because I wasn't here last time, so I'm going to play kind of annoyed, and you know, like, this isn't even worth my time, and tell. Well, actually, you already gave me the necklace, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna pull it out just a little bit to kind of show it, and then, well, never mind, this isn't even worth my time. I'm going to put it back into the bag of holding, kind of flash that a little bit, surely he recognizes that, and say, we'll be back when you have, more in stock, because what we have is worth far more than the one ring, so when you have, you know, more to trade, or, you know, have something else to offer, then we can barter.
His eyes kind of gleam at the jewels.
Sure, that's great.
Oh. But he's like, "Very well, friend. You're always welcome in Rashad's. I promise you, when my next shipment comes in, I'll have everything on display for your eyes to shine and wonder."
And Akka is going to walk out.
Yep, Mateo's going to go with him.
I will too.
All right. Maybe next time you guys can get that ring.
But yeah, and
I mean, I do have a criminal background.
No.
You do that's not we, want we, to we attempt have, that.
Mateo, we will have a talk about Akka's rules sometime, probably out of character, just so you guys have a better idea of who Akka is.
This land is all about respect and... what is it
this
called?
Is the land of Sakara. Honor drives everything.
Yeah, so if anybody finds out, we're all screwed.
Yeah.
I'm a spy, not a criminal.
though I will walk alongside Eladrin and be like, "I know you were looking for the ring, but I think you understand that we're not paying him the gold for that when we have the necklace." Okay. And so we will retire to the well, I will retire to the camel's hump. I will grab a glass of wine, sit at a table, and just people watch. Mostly because people tend to watch me.
Before, yeah. I'm going to go to Amira's and talk to her and explain to her that we're still looking for her supplies. We've cleared out a lot of the area and have found a temple.
Okay.
And explain to her we're looking for, that we're still looking for her supplies, and we have a hunch that they're in there.
Okay. She says,
"I'll go to the hump as well and see if anybody's playing bones at the moment."
I'm going to the hump and getting horribly fucked up.
Like, that's what most people do at the hump.
And you know what? Can I make a performance roll to see if I can make a little extra coin off of
stories and music?
That's actually in the DMG if you want me to look that up.
I know it is. can we say we do that when we come back next time?
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, because then I'll see if I can make any money off Bones, too, since I have a gaming set and I'm proficient in it.
Yeah, I just wanted to see if Amira would assist us in continually looking for it.
Do you guys should have spent a short or long rest in the camel's hump?
Well, let's do a long rest. We'll just stay overnight and then go back in the morning.
We're not leaving at night, yeah.
All right.
That is cold, bro. I do cold. That's cool. That's kind of my thing. But let's not travel during that. That's just uncomfortable.
Yeah. All right. The group, having just rescued, I just had her name, Fadia, has returned now to Fos Alam, resting after a solid day's journey through the ruined city of Isilungu. They count their spoils, they restore their wounds, and they return tomorrow to hopefully finish what they started.
And by tomorrow, we mean next week.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. We'll be back next week, same time, 7 o'clock p.m. EST on Thursday nights. Follow any of these guys' Twitters that you see on the screen. I think we have those up there now.
On where?
Yes. Do we have that. The Twitters available, or is it just the character names?
Just the character names. And they're level 3.
All right.
Fortunately, my Twitter handle is my character or my.
Good for
handle.
You. Mine is Malkior _. Just add an _. Anyway, and we'll try and get all the social media stuff up next time. But Amira's shipment is still missing. There's only a couple of women and corpses found. If they've been attacking caravans for months. Where's everyone else? What's in the cave? What does that key unlock? Find out next time on Sultans and Sorcery.
Have a good night, everybody.
Yeah.
Yep, I'm going to go watch Critical Role and eat dinner.
Hey, Mal, real quick, just because I noticed this on my...